Yeah.
But I swear
we're
everything.
Just on you.
I know. I
every
started.
one of us. We're all part of a team, but I swear every one of us is looking to fuck each other.
You gonna start playing the music or what?
I don't know. Are you fucking going?
I am.
He said he was
I
going.
I said I was going.
I'm not lying. I'm playing Pokemon Go right now, and I'm not listening to half the shit you're saying.
God damn it.
What are you doing? What are you just doing in Pokemon Go?
Like, I was releasing some Pokemon and I had extras up for my walk earlier. Pidgeys. Mainly Pidgeys. There was a fucking Rhydon. Is that the thing's name? Rhydon? Rhyhorn? I don't fucking know.
Rhyhorn's the smaller one. Rhydon's the one that stands on its legs.
Rhyperior is the fucking
one
huge
that's
one.
The not bipedal. The one that's on all fours.
That's Rhydon.
The one on all fours is Rhydon.
Horn.
Yeah, there was a Rhydon
that's
in my park.
Horn. Horn. Rhyhorn.
That couldn't find it. I was so sad.
Aw. I found one. I've found one before, and I had the chance to catch it, but then it left, and I was like, oh, I would have liked to get that.
Another Pokemon Go related topic, do you figure out what the fucking footprints mean?
Oh, the footprints? General vicinity to you. One footstep means it's really close. Two footsteps means it's a bit farther. Three footsteps means it's on the planet. I'm sorry, that's what happens, I swear! On the fucking
guess
planet.
You haven't found a Pokemon with three footprints yet.
Yeah, no, I haven't.
But hey.
Everybody say
one
who they are.
Well, more like, hey, it's a D&D Railed stream, it's been like 2 months.
Month and a half.
Has it been 2 months?
It's been about a month
yeah.
and a half.
Mainly 2 months. Oddly enough, we're still missing TLG from last time. He's still stuck in a portal or something.
Yeah, climbing a glacier or whatever.
Portal.
I have to go fight.
I'm not gonna lie, if anything good comes up on Pokemon Go, I'm running the fuck out, so don't be surprised
yeah,
if that
seriously.
Happens.
Yeah, seriously, you should have run out for the fucking Rapidash. Are you kidding me?
It's okay.
I should have.
I have a special intermission screen.
Yeah,
thing
apparently.
Is,
oh,
Rapidash
wait, it sucks.
It has GIFs, it has music playing on that one scene only. Hello?
It's bad.
It's
Rapidash
like,
is
awesome.
Actually
what does half
really...
of it mean? Like, what's the Warframe thing about?
It's a failed backstab.
Okay.
That's literally
How does
that
it. To, what, is that, what does that have to do with intermission or your channel or anything?
The GIFs are just supposed
he
to be like...
He Warframe!
Yeah, that too. And I stream it sometimes. The GIFs are just supposed to be like funny jokes, like haha anime or haha Yu-Gi-Oh.
It's. I don't you care.
Fuck.
I'm not gonna claim to
you
understand
to,
your logic.
You wanted to do a funny Yu-Gi-Oh thing, you should have just put a picture of Pot of Greed and said, and put what does it do as text.
That's negate attack.
I get it, because it does literally what the card says.
Yeah.
Good job, Nick.
You wow. No, but if you go on the subreddit, if you wanna get a shit fest, you go whenever somebody mentions Pot of Greed, just ask what does it do and then the fucking shitstorm starts.
No, fucking red. No, I just found these old Pokemon cards, but I have no idea what the fuck they do. The text is a bit fucking smudged. Just negate attack, Pot of Greed, and fucking it's another Mirror Force.
That's
well,
fucking
Mirror Force is a little harder.
Yeah.
Only a little,
also,
though.
Also, I found out a fun thing about the Captain Scarlet and the Torg DLC, at least. Badass.
Oh.
There is a level cap. It caps out at level 30. I'm using a level 41 Mechromancer.
Oh.
It
so
caps
we should
out at level 30.
Torg, like, immediately, right?
Well, right
yeah,
after would... main story.
No, because
would,
we're already
no,
level fucking
right
30. We're 31.
Right after main story, I mean, at least for me, I was like level 30. I was like level 35, so it was kind
of
like...
Here's the fucking thing, though. We do every side mission in every fucking area. We'll be level 40 by the time we finish the story.
But we want the XP.
Yeah, let's go do fucking Torg before it becomes trivial.
I mean, it's better when it's trivial. I mean, there are some quests... No, there are some quests I can't physically do because they're level 50.
Guys,
well, let's
can
get
we
the rest of
please begin the game? Thank you.
Okay. We're doing something else with this podcast.
We could turn it into a podcast at this point, and nobody would bat
an eye. Please no.
I mean, no. I would, because we don't stream the podcast.
Oh, it could be a first.
The first live Please podcast? No.
God, Please this no. music haunts my dreams.
Why?
How much I stress over this fucking D&D game?
A lot.
Very little?
A lot.
Very little.
I do a well, few things.
Had, well, you've
I try
had
to make
literally
it
a month to work to, like, prepare for this.
You think he works
yeah, I'm not
on
gonna
it
lie.
All the time?
I blew that off. Most. I started working on it yesterday.
Yeah. Kind of figured.
Why is this a... Oh,
well, can
hell.
We please can we please do this before my body decides to crash since I got in off my flight at 2 o'clock in the morning?
Are you
and I woke up at 11.
Not accustomed to the normal schedule anymore?
I was
the normal
really
schedule being
tired.
Nocturnal.
I was really tired yesterday. Okay.
Okay.
Because
what about
I
today?
I had two delays. Yesterday, I had to take two planes to get home. Both were delayed. And I got home at 2 in the morning. Can you please just begin this before my body decides, oh, nope, go to sleep. Got it?
Alright then. So, what happened last time on D&D?
Who the fuck knows at this point?
I don't fucking... Oh, we were gonna go... We were gonna... It was like left or right, we were gonna go right. That's all I remember.
Oh yeah, right. And then oh, Iggy okay. didn't I have the map.
All yeah, right. the map mysteriously disappeared or something, right?
Fucking... Let me find the fucking appropriate music for this shit.
Yeah, do that.
That was the one.
Thank you!
Oh god, that's loud.
Nah, not really.
It's all the way up. Alright, so fucking last time, we were here. You just came out, you decided to go north, you found your fucking tin buddy. Beagle Von Baron Esquire, the third, or... Scap, as you like to fucking call him.
Scap. Well, you put it in. You put it in once as Scap, and never gonna let you forget it anymore.
Yeah. Then we came. You found some fucking dead bodies on the previous screen, right? And you came out of the fucking cave, and you made up to this thing, which it said the fucking what was it? Oh, I know what happened. We were looking at the signpost, and the fucking didn't save the names I had for the towns, but I did rectify that.
Didn't we call it Right Town or something?
Right Town and Left Town, but I actually have names, being fucking Lequist Town to the left and Opal Town to the right.
Oh, really? You couldn't do something with an R?
Yeah.
It wasn't my... You know, I think the actual name was Ronce, but I fucking forgot and I put it as Opal.
Well, you can say it's Ronce now.
Alright, it's fucking Ronce Town.
Yeah. Alright, sweet. Wait, why does it have to be a town? Why can't it just have Ronce as its title?
I'm just saying as it is. It's a town.
Alright, sure.
I guess technically speaking, you don't want to say Phoenix Town, but fucking whatever. You know what it is.
Yeah.
Alright, are you guys not even here? I can't tell because,
oh,
like,
here.
You. I mean, like, your fucking tokens, are they not on the screen?
No, they're here.
My token's here.
Oh, I'm in the map, so I can't see them. Oh, there they are. Okay.
I can see. They're there.
They're right. All right,
so you're going.
Going to the right to Ronstown.
Yeah.
You're still keeping that fucking thing captive.
Fluffy? Yeah.
Oh, what the fuck? Oh.
The lag that ensues when you alt tab out of Borderlands.
Are you playing Borderlands still? Oh.
Maybe.
You can't prove anything. I'm missing a ghost, by the way.
No, you only had two.
Yeah, I don't see two. There's only one.
You only had two.
I know, but I only have one on me right now.
Top fucking... Oh god, what the fuck is happening?
Whoa. All
right, there's your fucking ghost, there's your fucking ghost.
Yay!
Okay.
Ghosties.
Alright, so you walk to the right about 2 hours. Not much to see on the scenery. It's really a barren, really just very plains-like area. You can see some more mountains up to the north, but very, very far away. So you just keep following the road for about 2 hours, and you start seeing a stone wall, which you can only assume to be the outskirts of Ronce.
Could I
and you've come up to the gate on the road. and there's two guards by it. As far as you can tell, they're doing their duty and up. What do you want to do?
Hello there.
Well, we can go with... Oh, wait, no, I can't make jokes about Tiny Tina because you motherfucker haven't played it.
I mean, I've played it, so...
I haven't played it, and I want to play through it the first time.
I could potentially get a joke that you make.
I could... Yeah, you could, but I don't want to ruin it.
Yeah. What does that mean?
What? Well, there's, like, a certain character between interactions always does a certain thing, and it's ridiculous, and it does, and it's freaking great. But all right, it's probably not the best. It's probably not the best way to resolve this situation. There's two guards.
Most solutions in Borderlands is shoot things, so
there's a little bit of talking.
All right, so we should probably talk to them, right? Let's go fucking talk to them. It can't be too bad. Hey, motherfuckers, how's it going? What's up?
Is that actually what you say?
No, it's not how I fucking say. Are you kidding me? Hey, is this Ronstown, or this is Ronstown?
Halt. Who are you?
We are a group of traveling adventurers looking for passage through Ronstown.
And why is that?
Because we felt like going this direction, all right? There was either this or the other town that's back there.
Lequus. Yes, we know. Lequus. Yes, but can you prove you're not spies for Lequus?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you're free to go through
all... The fuck was that, Nick?
You're free to go through all our shit. You're not going to find Jack.
Could be assassins.
Oh, my fucking God. Are you kidding me?
At this point, they're talking to each other and like trying to figure this out.
If we're assassins, we're pretty flashy assassins.
At this point, the two are talking to each other, like arguing. It's like, I told you this whole fucking wall system's not gonna work. How are we gonna let anyone in? It's like, but they could be assassins.
Nick, you fucking situational name piece of shit.
What?
Look at his name, he changed it. It's not a fucking scap.
Fuck you.
I realized what you were doing with the towns, and that's why I laughed.
What?
Nothing, it's my own shitty sense of humor.
You realize? Like, what am I doing with the towns, what?
It's my own shitty sense of humor.
Is it the fact that Lequus is left and Ronce is right?
No, it's something else.
What the fuck? Yeah, you know what's with Nick? I constantly just say normal fucking things. He's like, oh, I see what you did there. I'm like, I have no fucking clue what I did. I'm apparently the most elaborate motherfucking jokes in the world, and they're unbeknownst to me.
I guess I'm reading too much into it then, giving you too much credit.
You are.
It seems
you
like
are.
You calculated it. I don't know, all right?
What are you talking about? Explain this.
You're reading too much into it, Nick. You need to calm down.
Like, we come to Ron's, and then they're like, but you could be spies for Lequus. And then we go to Lequus and they're like, you could be spies for Ons. And then we're just stuck in between them because we can't go to either. Because they both think we're spies for the other. At least that's what I thought was going to happen.
You went to one side! What the fuck?
I know! Right. I was assuming that when we went to the other side, if we went there, that would happen.
You know what they say about assuming?
Yeah, it makes an ass out of me.
Specifically just you.
Yeah.
Alright, anyway. All right, so in the guard's voice.
Just you specifically.
We can't prove you're not assassins, but we also can't prove you are assassins.
Therefore, you'll let us in?
Therefore, we're going to ask you a question.
Oh, my God.
It's not anything. What's your fucking MO? What are you doing?
We are just looking to go this direction, actually. We just nothing... We're just wandering around, actually. We're not really...
We're adventurers lost on the path of life, and we decided to go right.
Like, really, we're just looking for quests and whatnot to do.
Alright. Well, if this backfires, we're losing our fucking jobs. We're probably getting executed, but fucking we can't prove shit. Fine, just go. At this point, they open the gate to Ron's.
Why, thank you.
Yay! Fine, fuck P.
Well, you did come at a good time, at least. There's some festives going on in Ronce.
Ooh.
Oh, festival!
Not
man, shit, you should have told us that.
It's
we would have been there for there.
It's the king's birthday. Nothing too big, nothing too flashy. Peasants usually don't do much in this event, but, you know, if you somehow get invited to royal court, maybe you can get in on a feast.
Mm.
Anyway, off you go.
All right. Thanks for the info. All
right, so after a little bit more walking, that's out again. I don't know if you guys hear it as loud as I hear it, but that's fucking loud in my ear. Went to Ron's after about 30 minutes of going through. All right, so you did pass on the way after, immediately after the gate, you did pass through mostly farms and houses. And in, like, the heart of Ronce now, where most shit is. It is a very, very small town.
Alright.
So we
there's people out in the streets walking around, seemingly just getting ready for tonight, like, getting preparing dinners and all that.
Oh, dude, this everyone's a bit excited. Let's talk to him. I'm talking to him. Fuck you guys.
This motherfucker
can you let Iggy, let Iggy finish explaining, please?
Nah, fuck
that's just
that.
It. Everyone's
I'm
excited.
Talking to the fucker with a sword. What do you got? What is this guy? What's your story?
Oi, shove off.
Why? What's going on here?
A guard.
Oh, you're guarding. A guard? Oh, you're a guard? Nah, that's boring. Fuck.
Well, excuse you.
Can you point out the buildings to us?
You do.
Yeah.
We don't know these buildings.
I mean, we can right. just well, ask the guard.
There's signs. See, there's a sign here. There's a sign.
In. Okay, so here's how this is fucking regular from this point. Signs mean it's a fucking place that you can enter slash it's something you'll use. There's not a sign in front of it. It's just a house.
But
so, like, that's a fucking...
Those. We can enter those
in.
If we get permission.
You know what I could probably shook and could do? I wonder if this works.
Hold make icons for them.
Experimentation! Yay.
Does
you know
this
what I
work?
Could do? Let me try doing things.
Could work. That work? I can't see it. Like, fucking the
change?
Sign should be giving off the in thing, but I can't see it at all. Is
did
it just too
change?
Tiny? Maybe it's just too tiny.
It might be too
so
tiny.
So that's an in?
That's the in up there. To the bottom, directly opposing from that, is just the smith. I think there's only other... Is there even anything else with the sign here? No, there's just an inn and a smith in this town.
All right. Oh, there's a sign right here.
Alright.
Oh. Oh,
let's talk to,
So that's probably the general store.
I'm gonna
yes.
talk to this person. Hey.
Alan's getting can't see them because they're in the wrong thing. It's like,
hey, you.
Hello.
Hey, what's going on in this town? What's happening?
Oh, it's just the king's birthday. We're all having celebrations tonight.
Okay. What's with the beef between this town and the other town, Leftquas or whatever?
Ah, yes. It's quite an old story. I'm surprised you haven't heard of it. Are you not from around here?
No, not particularly. I am not from around here.
Oh, well, I suppose
traveling
it won't take too long. All right, I can tell you. The story goes that there was two kings building cities in the frontier of the north, and
they happened to be brothers.
Had a bit of a land dispute. No, they weren't brothers. Not that cliche. But they got in a bit of a territory war over farmland and such. And as such, they two cities just held their own, and no one's really made a move.
Okay,
for
so
over
it's...
50 years. We've built up our defenses, they've built up their armies and defenses as well, and we've just kind of stood here. It's relatively peaceful.
So wait a second. You said it was a 2-hour walk to here from the crossroads, right?
Yeah.
You said half an hour.
Well, like, specifically from, like, that to the wall.
Okay.
Got it.
And then, like, another half hour from the inner wall to where you are now.
Alright, I guess that's not too far a distance.
At this point, it's like a bit afternoonish.
Alright.
Sun's still up in the sky.
So, you don't think there's any chance that they'll attack, like, you know, soon?
So there's always the danger, but we have walls and guards.
No, but specifically now. Like,
why now?
I mean, because you're all looking to do festival stuff, you know? Like, they might think that, oh, they're weak, they're doing festival stuff. No, they're not gonna pay too much attention to our...
Well, I'm no tactician, but I don't think a festival really lowers one's defenses. There's always the chance, of course, but no more than usual.
Yeah. Oh, whatever gets you, whatever floats your boat.
Well, anyway, have a good King's Day.
Well, anyway, hold on. Just one question. Do you own this store, or are you just standing around in front of it?
Oh, no, I'm just a patron.
Oh, okay. Alrighty. Well, guess I'll see you around town, maybe, depending on how long we stay here.
I guess so. I guess Ian's gonna do an action, so yeah, that's fine.
You know what's fucking...
Fucking, you're gonna need a d20 plus 16.
What's he doing?
So, let me look. You have to get a... I'd say 28 to get anything.
You roll a 2.
Okay.
18. Oh. So, while you're talking to this lovely lady over here, you feel some hands trying to get into your pockets, Chris.
Oh, my fucking god. Why do you do this, alright? Realize...
I don't know what you're talking about.
You realize that I've killed you once, alright? I have no guilty conscience about doing it again. It's nothing on my conscience to kill you again.
Is this Chaos talking or Chris?
I think it's Chris.
Hey, I have to do the occasional kleptomaniatism roll, so I have to pickpocket something.
Fucking do it to Nick. Do it to the lady. Not to me.
Do it to the ghost.
I don't think I'm going to get anything to the ghost.
So what the fuck? Do I just feel it and then I just smack him away like no? Or do I get a super easy... Do I have to do a super easy roll since he rolled?
You're aware that it happened. What you want to do now is up to you.
I'm gonna fucking smack his hands and be like, no.
Alright, well, you smack his hands away. You don't need to roll for that.
It's just a prank, bro.
Oh my god,
just a prank. Yeah, it'll be a prank when my sword ends up in your throat, alright?
Now.
I didn't catch what Chris said because it just sort of, like, cut out. Like, like his voice teleported, you know, that sort of thing.
Okay. Yeah, well, it'll be a prank when my sword's in your throat.
It's just a prank, bro.
Stan?
Now. Going to fucking... We don't need unrest amongst the party. Come on.
Stan.
Yeah.
If you're gonna try to steal from someone outside the party. Simple.
At this point, everyone's kind of looking at you like, what the fuck are they doing?
Fuck you, what are you looking
at? You just raised the middle finger at them.
Nothing's happening here.
Right.
I scream at them like, fuck, hey, what are you looking at? Nothing to see here. Go prepare for the king's birthday
or whatever. Totally not a fucking assassin.
If we are, we're the world's most incompetent.
We're also the most flashy, since I am... I don't know what your guys' characters actually look like, since I'm the one who designed mine, but mine's the most colorful rogue possible.
I don't even know how old my character is, much less what they look like.
But generally, I assume we're not going with the whole fucking usual thing of like anime lead characters of being in their teens. That's kind of fucking weird. I assume characters are all fucking at least.
Generally, at these times, like fucking medieval times, is usually if you're good with the sword, you're pretty fucking old. There wasn't many young hotshots. No Kiritos.
Like mid to late 20s, I'd say, or maybe 30s.
Also, is it true that SAO is getting a third season?
Seriously?
Yeah, I think so.
God damn it.
I think it is.
Why?
I didn't even watch the second. I was gonna plan on watching it, but I was just kind of like, fuck it, I don't know.
I haven't watched it at all, but from watching the top 10 thing, I now see why it's a terrible anime.
Okay, here's the thing. SAO portion of the first season, okay. At best. Elfheim's part of the first season, shit. Really shit. Second season is utter garbage.
They could have honestly ended it before Elfheim. That would have been it. I would have been fine. Everyone would have been fine with that ending. Cool, escapes. He escapes, he leaves, and nothing happens.
You know, they also could have made a good show from the start.
I don't even know if there's anything in like the fucking light novels at that point. I don't know if they're light novels or a manga, but I didn't think there was anything after Gun Gale.
No, they started as light novels. There's a manga that's happening, and now they're in anime.
I haven't heard anything beyond Gun Gale, so fucking, I don't even know.
Nah, whatever.
SAO, it's shit.
Yeah.
It's shit, unless you just like watching a dude stab things, which...
If you like watching generic protagonist stab things.
Yo, the best part about SAO is Kirito and Asuna, relationship-wise, but that's about it. And after the first three episodes, that's like seven episodes of Asuna not being there.
Best thing about SAO is the abridged series.
Okay, that's pretty good, too. Anyway, D&D.
Best thing about SAO? Not watching it, and then not having to worry about it.
It's probably even better.
Oh yeah, by the way, the current anime we're watching, just to detract one more time from the fucking thing, the opening of the show?
Yeah!
Did you notice something?
Like, the main guy is a giant.
What the heck are you guys talking about? Because I haven't seen anything.
Okay. Cross Angie, the opening.
Yeah.
Fully erect penis.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Another reason I wanted to watch the anime is I think when it was starting to be released, there was some... what is it? There was some... what the fuck is the word? Where it's like...
Censorship? Raciness?
No, not censorship. Controversy. Banterous. There's the word.
Controversy.
I think there was a rape in the show.
Oh.
That's
casual.
Kinda.
It's casual. You know, I never really noticed, but you know that, like, fucking that form of censorship where it's like, they don't block it out, but they remove the genitals like a fucking Barbie doll?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It doesn't work for men. Not really, because when the genital is physically there, but you just make it like a solid color, it's still there, and it doesn't really censor anything, so that shot is just hilarious.
Yeah.
I looked in the fucking comments. Please?
Like, I didn't see... I don't think it was in any of the other openings, just the first one. The first episode's opening.
Fucking way to open your fucking show. Penis in your face.
Yeah. Anyway, D&D.
So after you... Saying something?
When that happened, I laughed for a solid 2 minutes. I had to stop watching the opening.
The nice thing about me playing Borderlands and playing through the DLC at its super OP level means I do get the items again at a higher level, so I could transfer it to my other Mechromancer and give it to you.
Except for ones that cap out, like Torg, which you should really do right now. Anyway.
Well, no. Fucking... Like, we're around, like, we're like level 31, right? I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Just gotta work so we should back. Really we're like level 31. Yeah, we're like level 31. Yeah. My items, the items I have are level 30, so they should still work. Plus, they're like... the special one, so...
Ooh. But yeah, alright, let's get back. Anyway, fucking... So you had your spat. And I was just like, okay, that was weird, but whatever.
Guys?
So you're still just here.
Yeah,
you have your main objective.
So, I say we, split up for a while, reconvene in, like, an hour or something. Just, you know, look around the town and whatnot.
Okay, all right, well, there's four of us, so we'll split into two teams. Hold on. Hold on, this is not in team.
There's more than four of you.
Wait, No, well, there's more than four, but the one isn't here, so there's technically only there's three of us, plus the one extra we managed to convince to come along with us.
Plus the golem, plus the two ghosts.
I don't fucking count them. I don't fucking count those. They're Nick's shit. That's his problem. So the sword that I was bound to, isn't it in possession of Scap, right? Is that the
yes.
thing? Yeah, okay. So I'll go with Scap and you can deal with Mr. Klepto.
Yes, Squire. We shall train you.
I'm just gonna walk away. Like I'm gonna go explore.
Alright, that's fine.
Well, there goes the idea of teams.
Oh, yeah. Shag and Scoob fucking left the building.
Well, I mean, you can come with us if you want. I guess he can go on his own.
Yeah, why not?
Doesn't matter. Doesn't really matter what trouble he gets into.
Well, so I would. Well, before you said that you were going to go with Scap, I was actually going to ask Scap to come with me, and we were going to do like a sideshow thing.
No, Scap's coming with me.
I mean, that's ultimately up to Scap, right?
Fuck Scap.
You do realize you're not the performer anymore.
I know. But
he still wants to make money.
He's an empty suit of armor. I can use that to my advantage and make money off it.
That's
the performer's corpse is literally rotting in the astral observatory.
That's absolutely horrible. So Scap, do you want to be forcefully used to make money or do you want to come along an adventure?
That depends.
You'll be helping our adventure with giving us funds.
What exactly did you have in mind for a sideshow?
Oh my fucking god.
Well, your empty suit of armor, right?
Yes, and I don't like where this is going.
I can say that I'm like a puppet master, and that I'm controlling you as a suit of armor, and then I go through this whole, like, complicated, like, plan of, like, stuff.
Okay, Scap, that's just degrading.
Slightly. What are our funds, anyway? Depends.
Iggy, I have a few knives, a bunch of rocks, and two knives. That's all I have.
Iggy, please tell me you counted out the gold, because remember there was that whole shtick of fucking confusion.
Technically speaking, it's still conjoined, but you're pretty set, let's be honest.
I still haven't given any money.
Well, because you weren't there for the time when we got a whole bunch of money.
Yeah, that was the other guy who's now currently rotting in the other place.
Yeah, I know, yeah. I know.
So you're not getting any of that money.
But still, Iggy never gave me any funds to begin with.
You fell out of the sky.
You died. Honestly, they would have taken the gold back anyway.
And we did.
We're not talking about that currently.
We are! Anyway,
back to D&D.
What?
We've been talking about D&D!
Shut up. We are talking about the present, not the past.
Well, as tempting as it is, I'd rather not dance for these degenerates.
Yeah, so you're gonna come with us or you wanna go on your own adventure? Honestly, I don't give a fuck.
I feel more comfortable being with one of you.
Alright, come with me and fucking this other dude then.
Yo.
Right. Fine, I'll come with you.
Oh, good.
Team, let's split up. Let's all go this way.
Team, let's all split up. Yeah, let's all go in one direction. Motherfucker, I tried. Alright? I had a plan.
Alright. So, what is our plan?
Well, honestly, we could just split up and check each area, but let's go to the store since we're right in front of it.
Are we really just gonna check everything?
Yeah.
Recall, Master Gizbit did say this whole area, including the other town, was shrouded.
Yeah, it's kind of... It's
we're
kind
gonna
of
turn
a mystery.
Over every stone.
Not I mean, every stone, but Scap, when you're an adventurer, you do all the things.
That and, what is it? We have to, Since Gizbit was his name, can't look into here and see what's going on. We can't exactly. We have to look around.
You wouldn't think it'd be a more efficient way, but
well, we're sticking together.
I guess you've done this before, so we will trust you.
Well, we're sticking together. We're honestly going to split up, but now that you put it that way, it might be better just to stick together. Although, we're going to make sure Mr. Klepto right here stays far away from any of our pockets.
Very true, very true.
Then have me be with Scrap. He doesn't have pockets.
Yeah, but you can take a sword. Good. Yeah, you'll steal a part of him, and it'll be like, why would you do that to me?
Oh no, my leg.
I need all my parts to maintain form.
I wouldn't take a part of him. I only take things from pockets.
As far as we know.
What a very specific kleptomaniac.
Yeah, most kleptomaniacs kind of just take everything they physically can.
I've met a kleptomaniac, real talk. Yeah, you have to fucking hold them down.
Trust me, it'd be kind of weird to just steal your arm or something.
I would do it given enough incentive. Granted, no one's going to give me that incentive, so... You're okay
for now, Scout. You see a fucking phone? Like, you're at McDonald's, and the person across from you on the table just ups and leaves and forgets their phone. But you pick it up, and you're going to go give it back to them, but you see they were playing Pokemon Go, and they have a fucking legendary. What do you do?
They have a legendary and they've already implemented trading. I'd give myself the legendary and give it back. You kidding me? I'm not a good person when it comes to Pokemon.
Like, you help the elderly, but you volunteer, you clean up parks. As soon as Pokemon are involved, fucking you'll shove a little kid into a bus. Don't matter.
Okay, no, I won't do that. That's kind of mean, and especially since, from what I've seen, all Pokemon will appear for everyone. Like, it doesn't matter if one person catches it, it'll still be there for the other people. So.
Yeah, seemingly. Alright, anyway. You're trying to figure out your fucking party out right now.
Alright. Here's what I propose. I go with Scap, Stan goes with Chaos.
No. Horrible.
Alright. Here's what I propose.
Honestly, now that Scap has given his input, it's honestly probably better for us to go together.
True.
But, if I may, how did you find the last one of these tomes?
We fought a boss.
The first one?
Killed it.
The first one? Yeah, we fought a boss who then proceeded to knock out our last teammate.
Yes, how did you find it?
We were just adventuring around, honestly. It was like there was a couple of puzzles we had to do.
Specifically,
you're essentially saying you got lucky.
Yeah, specifically the reason we were there was because a guy was like, hey, people have died going into this cave. I want to know, trying to get something.
Oh, yeah, so we tell him the story of the Mafia.
Yeah.
Okay. So it sounds to me... Like you asked.
If you guys had like a big important person like guide you or something, why don't you go ask the king in this area then?
Guide you?
King, he's probably heavily guarded. We're not gonna get to him. It was hard enough to get into. It was hard enough to get into the friggin' town. You kidding me? You think we're gonna be able to see the king in 5 seconds? We gotta help
you
the town.
You talked to two guards. They had an internal fight, and then they let you pass.
That's true.
Yeah. I was about to say that.
Super difficult!
Very much so.
I'm pretty sure those two just got confused and just let us pass because they didn't know what to do.
Hey, Metal's here. What's up?
Yeah. The one badass token. Motherfucker.
I don't know how long you've been here. I just fucking opened Twitch chat, so.
He's been here since 12:24.
Pretty long.
Anyway, I propose we ask around.
Well, if we truly want to get to the king, we're gonna have to do stuff around here to help the townsfolk. So maybe he'll actually invite us.
I mean,
we're not just gonna walk willy nilly in there.
We could just walk up, ask like, "Hey, how do I go see the king?" And they'll be like, "Hey, I don't know, do good stuff." Like, it is the king's birthday, so we could just say when you want to say happy birthday to him and whatnot.
There's probably a celebration where we could do that safely.
We can do my traveling performer's idea.
Yeah, we're not using Scap, though. Do you have any notable skills of entertainment?
To be totally honest,
I could probably juggle knives, maybe.
You know,
you can turn invisible. I highly doubt that counts as entertainment in a fucking era where that's probably normal.
You know, the performance idea could actually work.
Doing. He told you.
So we perform in the middle of town, and since it's a festival, people will be like, yeah, 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 keep going, woohoo, and whatnot. This could potentially get the king's attention, and then he'll invite us.
See, I told you my plan would work.
I'm not opposed to the idea of performing.
We just have to figure out what...
Now that you no longer have the character that was literally based around performance, you want to do a performance. Go figure.
Well, don't forget, the entertainer could literally just do entertainment solo. We have to do it as a team.
Motherfucker, there's a fucking buzzard mission.
Look, all I'm saying is that it has the potential to work. We should still see out all our options first before we decide on just performing in the middle of everything, you know?
Currently, what time is it in-game?
In-game, it's about fucking 6 o'clock.
P.M.?
At night or...
P.M.
What? P.M. It's been so long.
It was already fucking in the morning. Not in the morning. P.M. Oh. Not at morning. A.M. is the morning.
Sorry, my clock says A.M. right now.
Like, are we in Arizona in the summer? Because you said the sun was really high up.
I didn't say that. I didn't say that at all.
You did.
I said the sun was up. Oh. I didn't say it was high up.
All right.
So it's almost nighttime. Okay. Well, since it's almost night, how about we go find some place to sleep?
That could be useful.
Though, we should probably take advantage of the king's birthday before it, you know, stops being his birthday.
So, do the performance now, then?
Let's ask around for, like, 20 minutes. See what...
Well, figure out who we need for the performance, and we'll go find some... We'll go find a place... Wait, no, the end's right there. No, we're good. Actually, you know what? I'll go figure out sleeping. You guys enter. You guys will do the performance. What do we need? How many rooms do we need? Scott, do you mind sleeping in any of our rooms?
I don't sleep.
Okay, do you mind standing in any of our rooms? Or outside of... Or do you mind standing in any of the rooms?
If you'll tolerate my presence, then that's fine.
All right.
Okay.
We only need
Ooh, I just had an idea for the performance. Guys, I just had an idea for the performance.
Okay, right. you talk to them about it. I'm gonna go to the inn.
Alright.
Scap, exactly how heavy is your armor?
No more than usual, I suppose. I'm not quite sure.
That's not quite what I meant. Because since you're just armor, how much do you weigh compared to a normal person?
Probably significantly less.
Okay, here's my idea.
I have no idea how much fucking armor weighs comparative to a person. I imagine it's pretty heavy, but...
Armor usually weighs about 25 pounds, I would say, depending
But collectively.
Yeah, as a collective, it usually weighs like 25 pounds total. Because
I find that hard to believe.
The thing is, though, like, do you think it's too heavy or too light?
Yeah.
Let's just say 50 pounds. Find a compromise there.
I mean, it depends on the type of armor as well. Like, if it's
iron.
Like,
he's just full iron.
He has full plate. He has full plate armor.
Like,
so
that'd be like 35, I think.
I'm gonna say 50.
Because the armor can't be like 50. The armor can't be like 70 pounds unless, like, the guy in it is, like, super strong.
Look how much a fucking normal fucking knight's armor weighed. I imagine it's significantly over 50.
How much does plate mail weigh?
The plate mail is just a piece, isn't it?
Yeah, plate mail.
Full plate mail is 110 pounds.
Oh shit, really?
Right. Let's just say 100 then.
That is full plate. That is full plate armor.
Going 100 final.
All right, sure. Okay.
How much can a normal person carry? I'm gonna have to go.
That depends
now.
On how much they've worked out. It's honestly like there's no set. Everyone's different.
We would just use the strength roll for that, I'd say.
But strength rolls would be a thing. But, like, real-world equivalents is, I mean, pound for pound, actual babies are stronger than oxes. Hmm. Humans are pretty fucking strong. A human can pretty easily lift 100 pounds when they try to.
Yeah.
Should we try to base this off strength stats?
We are going to do that. I'm just talking real life here.
So,
but here's my idea. Since Scap is technically lighter than probably all of us, and he's in a full suit of armor, say one of us is the strong man and lifts him up, a man in full plate armor. Right?
Okay.
Problem.
It should be noted, all your stat strengths are the same at 14.
Good, but I'm not there.
But I'm the tinier one, so...
Height does not matter in strengths.
I know, but since I'm the smallest one, I will have like a bigger impact. He's like, I'm strong, tiny person, you know, that sort of thing.
Okay, there's that, I guess.
So, Stan, problem with that is, if they have you lift anything else, you could potentially just fail on the spot. Because
you fucking fail, he drops down the well.
Yeah, and considering you're a strong man, they'll be like, hey. Raise this person up as well. Why not? You're a strong man. Do it. And then it's going to end awfully.
No, I'm not there. I'm not there, but then you could switch to the puppet act where he puppets Stan into the...
Gaming Ancient Ninja, hello.
Yo.
You're a new one. You're not a mod, so you must be new.
Does Stan have the same strength?
We have a new person. Hooray.
Does Stan have the same strength as us?
Yeah, everyone's the same. Technically speaking, the highest strength among you is Scap at fucking 16.
Ooh.
Oh.
No, 18. Yeah. Holy
18?
Shit.
18? Damn. What's his intelligence?
He has a magical... I can look that
we
up.
We can do like the totem pole sort of thing.
His int is 14.
Alright.
In case you've forgotten, it's fucking strength 18, dex 15, int 14... Wisdom of 9, Vit of 27, and a...
Damn, I forgot he had a lot of health.
It's just a fucking tank. Almost literally, he's fucking just iron.
Yeah, I can see that.
Oh, Gaming Ancient Ninja. Basically, if you stay in the chat for more than 15 minutes, Nick, SooperMrNinja, will probably give you mod because it's a fucking joke.
It's not... What do you mean it's a joke?
He will mod anyone at this point.
He will literally mod you. You do not even have to pay him. He's a mod whore.
Why would I pay somebody to... What?
No, they would have to pay... Like, some people pay for mod shit.
Really?
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah.
It's more, like, prevalent on shit like if you want to pay for adminship in some sort of server of a game or something.
I guess, but... Like, I don't really care who gets mod. Like, if you want to come in here and, like, do a
Cervantes,
thing, sure.
Cervantes, 2K. Yeah. You're also not a mod, so you must also be new.
You must be new. And if you're not new, tell us you're not new, and maybe Nick will mod you.
If you're not new, Nick will mod you on this fucking spot.
Hey, God, I'm gonna... Fuck it.
Is he gonna start having standards?
Your machip is about worthless than fucking, wow, words. Like, about the equivalent of the fucking euro right now. Or not the euro, the fucking pound.
I like seeing the sword next to people's names. What can I say?
You're raising a fucking army.
I mean, that's what I'm doing. Are you kidding me? I have so many Pidgeys in Pokemon Go, it's not even fucking funny.
Fucking Pidge squad can attack.
Can we go back to our, performance discussion?
Sure, why not?
Watch the whole idea get fucking shot down. Like, when he's like, we shouldn't do it, and just looking all this time, whoop, just gone.
Like, I don't like the strongman act, alright? It seems too fishy.
Too many points of failure.
How about we do the, like, totem pole thing, where the strongman holds more people on top of him and that sort of thing.
I don't like the strongman act, but what about the strongman act?
No, that was us. That was us lifting Scap.
Still, I just don't like it. There are too many points.
But pull on him.
where it can just go.
If it can carry two bad. People, that means two of us can probably at least carry one another person. I don't think any of our characters are strong enough to carry another person.
Of course, you do realize this is all still down to dice roll. You have 14 strength, so it's going to be a dice roll.
It is, but I assume at least there's got to be a minimum that we can do it. Like, if we roll a 2 and don't critically fail, there's got to be a minimum.
I can do acrobatics with the ghosts or something. Like the swinging rope things, you know, in the circuses?
You know, I just realized the fact that we have ghosts and I can summon them, we could use that as, like, a performance. Like, ooh!
I mean, soulstones, that are a thing in the world already.
Oh. It's not special or anything?
No, not really. Necromancers are the thing.
Oh, alright.
I mean, but a fucking empty suit is not too normal.
Question, empty which suit. One of us has the most dexterity? I think that's me, right?
I will check. Chris has 13, Nick has 15, and you have 16. So...
By Uno.
Okay. How about your ghosts help me do like a flying trapeze act?
The fuck? Nigga, we play D&D or a circus right now.
Oh, I think I know what he means.
Because you know how trapeze usually have those ropes and swings and stuff? How about the ghosts help me with the trapeze stuff with them holding like rods and stuff that I can swing from?
I like that.
And then at the grand finale, I'll disappear.
At what point do I start talking to the in person?
I guess you can leave and do that, but I mean, they're just talking tactics.
So I already well did that. I said I was going to go leave and do that. Fucking hell.
All right.
Stan, I like it. Let's do it.
All right, I'm going to the inn. Fuck you guys.
I didn't want to fucking cut off their conversation, besides the times that we cut off their conversation to talk about Pokemon or something. Anyway, you know, sure.
Anyway, real quick, Stan, I like it. Let's do it.
I'm out.
Hooray!
I am going to secure shelter for you fuckers. Okay, bye.
All right.
So you're at the inn. You go inside. There's just a fucking small man manning the fucking counter.
That's it? There's only this guy? Are you kidding me?
What guy? It's not visible on the map right now.
No, I know, but there's only one guy in here? There's not, like, a good amount of people?
There's just one person manning the counter.
Oh, who else is in here?
No one that you can see.
Oh, really? Okay, cool. There's no one else here. Or no one that I can see. Alright, well, let's go up to the counter.
He welcomes you in. And beckons you to the counter.
I'll walk to the counter. Hello.
Welcome. What can I get for you?
I need 3 rooms for the night.
Oh, all right. That will come up to 45 gold.
Oh, so it's 15 gold a room?
Hey.
Okay. Sorry to make this any harder, but is there a chance the rooms could be really close to each other?
As I remember, there's 3 up on the upper room if you line those. The ones on the downstairs are a bit nicer, but we can go upstairs.
They're not close to each other?
On the downstairs, only 2 are close to each other, and one's on the other side of the hall.
Okay, no, we'll take those. That'll be fine.
On the bottom or top? What?
We'll take the... I'll take the bottom ones. That's fine. That one's not close.
You have your own money at this time, so I assume you just pay him, and that'll be it.
Yeah, I'll pay them, and I'll take note of how much it costs for each room, so I can deduct it from the other guys later.
Alright, fucking... Sure. There. So you got 3 keys, you then is like, alright, have a good day.
Yeah, nice. You too.
Is that it? Is that all you want to do?
I'm gonna go into each of the rooms. I'll go into one room, and then I guess, I don't know.
Like
do you
the
want
ones that you purchased, or like
yeah,
random rooms?
The ones that I purchased. Can I open random rooms?
No, probably not. They have keys.
Yeah, no, I'll go to the ones that I purchased, and just the keys for the ones I have, so I can look at that.
Alright. So you go down the hall, you find one of the rooms that, like, the 2 rooms that are adjacent to each other. You go into the right room with one of the keys. It took you a few seconds to figure out which, because they all look the fucking same. Because that's fucking convenient. You get in the room, and it's a fairly nice room. There's one pretty big bed, some paintings. It has a bathroom, even.
Okay.
Jarred flower. It's a very nice room, all things considered. There's even a fresh apple on the bed. Nothing much notable apart from that.
All right. Well, do we want to switch to them, or do I get to go through the other rooms?
I'm gonna go to
every room.
All the rooms are the same.
Oh, they're all legitimately the same?
Pretty much.
Oh. There's just a difference in location.
You did note the one room that was not adjacent is fairly far from the other rooms, but that's it.
Okay. Well, I guess I'll leave then and try and go to the smithy.
Alright, well, while you're doing that, we'll go to the other fucking guys. Alright, so if you've devised your master performance...
Hang on one more thing. Matchy, I just had an idea for, like, another act that we could do for the performance thing.
No, it's okay. The trapeze will work fine.
Will it,
no,
though?
I mean, we're gonna need more than just one performance. Like, quickly pass me something.
I mean, the
like,
thing
anything.
Is, with the trapeze act, we can just have it, you know, be all over the place. Like, we can have the ghost spin around and all that. We can have...
Yeah, to answer the question in chat... The addition of this game is my addition. It's generally fuck all the rules, I do what I want.
We can have them loosen and strengthen the tightness of the rope, so that way it's much harder for you to actually stay on.
I know, but I just had an idea for another act in case, like, the trapeze isn't quite enough. Like, a simple disappearing act of, like, an item. Like, Scrap, can I borrow your sword for a moment?
I'd rather you didn't.
Here's a rock.
Don't worry. Right, don't worry, you'll give it back. You'll get it back.
Remember how Scap didn't come with a sword?
Yeah, but it's your sword that you gave him.
It is. Mm-hmm. Well, Nick gave him the sword that he had.
Yeah.
Which, we'll see how that plays out for everyone.
Well, just give me something so I can do the trick.
I give him a rock. I just pick one up off the ground.
Ian, you literally have infinite rocks.
I know, but I needed them to give me something. Okay, see this rock? I shall make it disappear. I put it into my cloak, and I take off my coat, and I, like, show them the coat, and I say, "Where's the rock?" I put the coat back on, and then I pull out the rock.
You put it in your bag thing.
Right. My coat is how I access my infinite storage thing, remember?
Wait, what the fuck?
We discussed this. You just forgot.
So, he could just put it in his thing, but what if they want to... only you can access it then, right? You can have the crowd look like actually touching it and try to look for it.
Right.
Maybe, hopefully.
I think whoever wears the coat can access the shit inside of it.
No. I thought it was only me.
Well, I mean, that would make it more balanced, so we don't lose any story items if you happen to be carrying them and die.
Yeah, whoever wears the coat can access the bag.
We already discussed that. We already discussed that if I die or something, that the items in it that are, like, important to the story...
I'm the DM, I do what I want!
...level or pop out. Okay, fine.
I'm a DM, I do what I want. Good.
Honestly, logically, it makes more sense that whoever wears it can access it, because bugger all if it fucking doesn't work like that.
Well, that's nice. It's nice to know that...
Fine, but only one person can access it at a moment's notice.
Sure.
Okay.
I mean, it does take a while.
So basically, if I'm, like, holding the jacket, people can't, like, go into it.
Yes, whoever's in possession of it.
Because they're not fucking wearing it!
Well, true.
Whoever's in possession of it, we don't have to fucking go into the details of what possession is. We know what possession is. Go on with whatever the fuck you're doing.
And so then I take off my jacket, I have them try to, like, look for the rock. I put it on the jacket again, then I pull out the rock. Maybe two rocks.
Rock or two.
I mean, honestly, would it be more impressive if you just dumped out a shit ton of rocks?
Considering you have infinite rocks, I think it would be more impressive to just see all those come out, yeah.
Can he make them come out like a fountain, though?
Can he?
I have to take them out one at a time.
Damn it.
That fucking sucks.
If my hands can reach in, that's how much I can take out.
It's still infinite rocks.
Like I could go like, Yeah.
Just, like, pump them out.
Have you considered, like, business in quarrying instead? It seems like that'd be more valuable.
We could also do jokes while I do it.
What?
Jokes. Yeah, somebody could tell jokes. What's your joking ability, guys?
That'd be based off our charisma, I think.
Pretty much.
My charisma is 12.
Fucking Chris's charisma is 6. Go. Oh, no, wait, it's 10. Excuse me. Nick's charisma is 9.
I'm the most charismatic.
What about Stan? Oh. Or Stan's not, no, just not any.
And fucking Scap's charisma is 10.
Scap.
I'm the most charismatic.
Technically speaking, yes.
Okay, you guys work on jokes while we go to... well, what are we doing now? Since
why
we
would he
have...
work on jokes? You're the most charismatic. You work on the fucking jokes.
Hey.
You know, I figured...
Also, I'm not here.
This tome hunting business would be a little more straightforward than it is.
Well, unfortunately, yeah, this has to be going around and doing a lot of things.
I mean, you're not here to talk any, though, so...
Yeah, I'm here in spirit, fuck you.
Well, you see, the thing is...
Get...
This is... what this could be one of the best ways to actually... get to the king.
Isn't there a radar or something for this? A magical compass?
A radar?
No, there isn't.
I mean, there is. Wait, is there?
No, there isn't.
Did we get a fucking radar?
No, there isn't. It's just a Gizbit talking like, hey, I can't see this place. Go there.
I'm a little bummed by all this, to be honest. I think it'd be a little bit more robust adventuring, not trapeze artists and rock puns.
Look, sometimes you have to go between a rock and a hard place.
The okay. Is very...
Look, he look stand stoned right now. All right, just ignore him.
What the fuck was that?
Hey.
Ignore or him, like ORE. Ignore him. Get it?
No.
That was pretty.
Nobody
that was pretty bad, Matchy. That was pretty bad.
Granted, yeah, it kind of was.
If I didn't fear the gnomes in that cave, I'd probably go back to my post at this point.
Well, you suck with us.
So what the fuck are you fuckers doing? You gonna execute this plan or
yes,
what?
Yes, we're executing plan. Alpha, Delta, Mega, Omega. Go.
Well, since you, let's have Chris do whatever the fuck he was doing since this just finished up. Chris, what the fuck are you doing?
I was going to the Smith.
Alright. The Smith is directly across from the inn. You walk down, you hear a bit of the idiocy. The fucking stupidness that's going off over there.
Idiocy.
You decide to ignore it and go down to the Smith. You open the door to the Smith and it's a very burly bearded man smacking away at an anvil. He grunts and acknowledges you and that's about it.
Okay, not the most... sort. Probably not. Hey! Hey, Smith, how's it going? Doing anything special for the festival?
Working.
Alright, well, do you know if there's like an adventurer's guild around here? Town I came from had one of those. Or at least a place where I can maybe hire people to do things.
Town small.
No guild. No guild? Shit. That's not good. Well, thanks for your time. Does he have any wares yet?
He has swords, anything you're really looking for in terms of weaponry or armor. Arrows, bows,
Not really looking for anything. Like last game I bought a sword. I remember that.
Yeah, you did. You found so secret purchase a sword.
Yep, so what was the damage of my sword and what's the damage of my new sword?
I have it written down somewhere. I will find it. Fucking, it did like...
I know it did 2. I know it did 2 Ds.
I think it was like 2d7 as opposed to like 2d4.
Oh, it was 2d4 my original sword?
Yeah, I think it was 2d7 if I'm remembering correctly.
Okay, well, might as well. I'll pull that out for a fight. Okay, well, I'll pop outside and see what's going on.
Alright, so you're done there, your fucking clown group. What are you doing?
We're performing.
Where do you want to do this?
Right next to the fountain. Or, well.
Alright. Alright, move over to position. Yes. So how do you want to structure this? What are you doing first?
Oh, really quick, I want to ask how long my ghosts have left.
Probably like an hour or two. Honestly, I don't remember when you summoned them, so I'm going to assume 2 hours.
Alright.
They're not going to disappear during the act as long as you do it right fucking now.
I was hoping they would, to be honest.
Okay, so are we ready to begin?
Yes. Come one, come all. See this man jump on a wire. Yeah. He'll walk between it. He'll walk on it. He'll jump on and off it. Whoa, the wonder. You start your act.
Okay. I have Squire attend me, lift me up, and then throw me to prove yourself. You're gonna have to move them.
What?
Well, this is... Okay. So someone else who's not modded, so I guess is new, fucking K-Crash. Fucking how do levels work? Levels are basically, I keep track of their experience and they get levels. At certain levels, they get abilities and shit. That's basically it. It's all up to me. Some things, like, mostly they get EXP from fighting. Besides that, they can get EXP through some other special actions.
Alright then, so I have my ghosts put a wire between them and, like, each hold each end of it.
How long are your ghosts gonna last, though?
About 2 hours, I said. That's yeah, most okay. I have left.
And so I begin walking the wire between the two ghosts. You're gonna,
yes.
Okay, I guess we'll do it this way. Hang on. I guess we'll do it this way.
And so I have the ghosts go up, like, 10 feet off the ground, and just have them keep walking back and forth.
Some people are interested. They're like, oh, what the fuck's going on over there? What are those fuckers doing? Some people are, like, nodding their head, like, ah, that's pretty cool. Nothing too mind-blowing, but sure, pretty good.
And now they start spinning.
Whoa. Alright, so
by spinning, I mean, like, this way.
I get it. I get what you're saying. Yeah. So, Ian...
So I stay in the middle of the rope to stay balanced.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Anyway, you're gonna have to fucking roll for this, anyway.
Okay.
We're gonna do is a d20 plus 16. I'm gonna say for this is a fairly good... Like, you're gonna need a 26 or higher.
Okay. At least a 10.
Hey!
28! You managed to keep your footing, and you're doing it pretty spectacularly. You don't look like you're gonna fall off, and people are cheering. So far, it's a success.
Okay, I'm gonna drop down from the wire and do a spin off and then land on top of it again.
That's another roll.
That's...
Wait, explain that one more time. I don't think I heard all of that.
Yeah.
Okay, you know how gymnastics, spin on the pole?
I can't say I'm a patron of gymnastics, to be totally honest with you. Just explain what you're doing again, that first explanation.
Okay, I'm going to jump off the wire, grab it, and then spin around on it back on top of it.
Okay, I get what you're saying.
It's going to spin around on the...
Okay, so there's going to be, I think, 2 individual rolls. No, let's make it 1. Fuck it.
All right.
I'm not that fucking... Let's just make it 1 roll. Once again, d20 plus 16 because of your dex. And okay. This is a fairly hard roll.
It's not too difficult since I'm grabbing the wire.
Well, firstly, you jump off. Then you have to fucking grab the shit. And then you have to spin on it jump back up and land on it. You're gonna need at least a 30.
That and it might be easier if the ghost stops.
When I jump back on it, I'm still grabbing it. Like, I jump off it, I grab it, and then I spin back on top of it.
I'll bump that down to a 28, then. Fucking 28. D20 plus 16. Good fucking luck.
29.
Hey, you did it.
You're so lucky you fucking convinced me to bump it down, motherfucker. Alright, so you execute that move, and people are liking it. People are cheering. It's a spectacular show so far. Some people have thrown gold at you.
Grazie them.
What does grazie mean?
Like, give thanks to them. Like, kneel down on the wire and be like, yes, thank you all for watching. Or something like that. Grazie them.
Okay, I'm going to hang from the wire from one hand. I'm going to say, thank you, thank you, thank you. There's still more to come.
And as he...
Just give us money.
As he hangs from the wire, I have them go up another 5 feet. So now they're like 20 feet in the air.
All right, sure. I'm not even going to make you roll for that because it sounds simple enough. Sure.
Okay.
Is your performance done?
Okay, I'm going to do one last trick. I'm going to hold onto the wire with both hands. I'm going to have the ghost, like, spin the wire like a jump rope with me on it.
Okay. This is a trick?
Yeah.
All right.
Then I'm
I mean, considering he's 20 feet in the air.
Sure. I heard, and then I'm gonna, and then he cut out. Does that happen for anyone else?
Oh. Okay, so can you make your ghost do that while I hold on to it?
Well, say again for Iggy to hear.
Okay, I'm gonna be holding onto the wire with both hands. I'm gonna have the ghost swing the rope like a jump rope, like jump rope motion while I hold on to it.
D20 plus 16, say for this, 25. No, not even, 24.
I did it.
All right, fine. You successfully executed your trick. The crowd's eating it up like fucking yogurt on a hot day.
Okay, I'm going to need the ghost to drop me to 10 feet. Like, drop the wire back to 10 feet instead of 20 feet.
They go and up then another 10 feet?
No, I actually need to be lower to the ground for this to work.
It's okay. They go up another 10 feet. So now there's 30 feet in the air.
Great.
I was going to do the... black egg and disappear, like fall off the wire and to go poof.
And now the ghosts drop 20 feet like in an instant.
Jesus.
Alright, then I let go of the wire and activate my black egg ability and go invisible as I hit the ground.
Alright, so in the air you'll activate black egg and you turn invisible. I'm gonna have you roll for your landing though.
Okay.
So, once again, it's Dex. D20 plus 16. Get a 24.
Oh! Great.
You're perfectly fine. You land pretty good. No one can see it because you're fucking invisible, but you didn't hurt yourself.
I mean, doesn't my black egg ability happen like smoke or something?
Yeah, it poofs.
Yeah, so like, as I hit the ground, I poof.
Great.
And so...
No one can see your landing.
Right, but as soon as I hit the ground, I go poof, and I'm gone.
Right. What's the problem here?
That can mean a lot of things, Ian. Like,
he said that I disappeared while I was falling.
Yeah, basically, Ian wants to fall down on the ground, and the second he hits the ground, he wants to activate Black Egg and disappear.
That's fine. You can activate Black Egg whenever. So you did it. Okay. You poofed. Now what?
Thank you all for coming. It's been a great time.
And Yay! Then I reappear out of, like, say, the fountain, or not the fountain, the,
well,
or whatever. Like, I climb out, visible and stuff.
When did you get in the well?
He just climbed down
I was
there,
invisible,
I guess.
Just go with it.
Sure. So you climbed in the well, managed yourself from not falling down the well, and you climbed back up. Sure.
Thank you all for enjoying.
We would like to thank you all for viewing our performance.
Our names are Maxi
and
Stan. And then, yeah, we bow.
I guess I was here too.
Shut up, Scap. You didn't do anything.
I honestly thought I had a part in this, but I guess not.
So not what?
The first time I've been shafted on my position. I'm quite used to this.
Scap, you could have told a joke or two, if you really wanted to.
My life.
So what's the crowd
laugh? Do the crowd laugh too?
Just like awkwardly applauding.
Because this just became a comedy routine.
All right, so what happens now? Do they like walk away or?
Basically, everyone just starts going about their business. All
right.
Scat picks up all the gold.
I was about to say.
Picks up about 20 pieces of gold. It's like,
I will add that to the inventory for our group.
Can I take it since I have nothing?
I'll give you half. So you get 10
Deal.
Gold.
I know. Well, might want to give him 5. I want to give him 5 more gold because he needs to cover his damn room.
Actually, wait, no, we split it 3 ways since Scap did help a little, I guess.
Scap wasn't there! You talked about
it! He helped a little. Alright, so I give Scap 6.
About 8. Yeah.
Scap 6, me and Stan 7.
So he takes it and he's looking down as in, like, I don't have pockets.
Oh, I'll just hold on to it for you then.
I take his coins, open his face guard, and just drop them in.
Stan! Why?
This feels weird. They're in my boots.
Oh my god.
You just kind of hear them clanking about in his boots.
Do you want us to take them out? Or...
I'm gonna have to, but I have to take off my boots, and I need all my pieces to maintain form, so as soon as this happens, I'm gonna collapse.
Just sit down against the fountain.
No, he's gonna collapse. Yes. Like,
every piece, like, the way he's held together is by magic. So when a piece of him is taken off, all of it collapses.
Let's just, alright, so, chaos.
We can have the ghosts hold him up.
But everyone...
They have to hold up every individual piece of that piece of armor.
Alright, so, Chaos was going to look for an inn or something, so we'll just go see what he's doing. Sound good? See if he got us an inn, or whatever, rooms.
I suppose.
Alright, let's do that.
And we walk to the inn with Scrap clanking with us.
Alright.
And I just watch them walk by.
So what are you up to, Chaos?
No, I'm not there. I was outside. You guys are walking to the inn. Okay, bye.
I know. What are you doing at the Smith, Chaos?
Oh. What? No.
You named yourself fucking Chaos. What a weird.
You guys are going to the inn. I'm outside. So. No.
You know, we never really did say where we were going to reconvene.
So, I have a question. What did that do for us other than get us our knight's fee?
Didn't, but...
It was supposed to get, like, the king's attention, and he was supposed to come out of wherever he is and be like, oh, hey, that's a pretty cool performance, yeah.
That didn't seem to work.
We probably should have gone with the multiplying rock trick.
Oh, my... Alright, so he'll probably hear about a somewhat good performance tomorrow, so... Actually... It is getting somewhat late.
It's about... I'd say that performance took up half an hour. It's about 6:30, right. 7.
I say we go grab Chaos and go see the king. Or try to, anyway.
Holy shit.
I suppose.
It wouldn't have been enough time for him to hear about us yet.
Still, like... Timing is everything, and if we go tomorrow when it's not his birthday, he'll be less inclined to see us.
You're probably right.
Well, onward then.
Yeah, let's go grab him, wherever he is.
I'll just clank along.
So, yeah, we look for Chaos. Anyway.
Where is he?
He's outside of the Smiths now.
Ah, there he is.
You probably see him. Let's be honest. You see him.
Yo.
Blank.
So, performance went well. Blank. We got like...
Blank.
We got like, 20...
Blank!
we got like 20 gold out of it, and I don't think it actually affected the king in any way, shape, or form, but we might as well go see him before his birthday's over.
20 gold? Is that all you guys got? Holy fuck.
I also
so much more
got
money.
This young maiden's carrier pigeon number.
Why didn't you use that joke in the performance?
Not a joke.
That was...
Oh.
I don't think she knew I was just a fucking magical being, but... I scored.
Alright, sure. I high-five him.
Blank.
His arm goes flying.
It's magically attached, it's fine.
Anyway, let's go see the king, or try to, anyway, before his birthday's over. Sound good?
I concur.
Alright, let us go.
Yeah, all of us, including Chaos, right?
What's your input on this, Chris?
Wait, did they find me?
Yeah.
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 Fuck. Fuck. Yeah, we can... I mean, kind of wanted to go around town. You guys can go see the king. I don't think you guys are going to even make it to the fucking king. All actually, right. No, I'll come. I'll come. All actually, right. No, I'll think about it. I'll come.
Okay. Let's go see the king.
Blank. Clank.
Stop clanking. Clank. Stop it. Clank. Stop it.
I can't help it.
Yes, you can.
There's gold in my feet.
That doesn't matter.
Does. Kind of does.
I mean, only a little.
It's a fucking magical being problem, you flesh bag.
Flesh bag.
Wouldn't understand.
I wouldn't. Hello.
Wait.
Just completed the Tiny Torg DLC.
Tiny Torg? Tiny Torgs? Assault on badass peeps.
I mean, Torg is here and so is Tiny Tina, so fucking hell.
Tiny Torg.
Torg.
We would like to wish the king a happy birthday.
We'll send your fucking... You'll send your blessings with us. You're not getting in.
We have a performance for him.
Yeah, no.
I mean, I assume these guys can see over here, right?
Yeah, we saw it. We're not letting you in.
Fair enough.
Okay.
Wow, okay, you guys gave up real easy.
You're here too, you know.
No, I'm not, I left. Oh yeah, I did come. Fuck.
PMI.
Uh-huh.
God. Why the fuck would I come with
it? It took a second.
Oh, yeah. I thought maybe we had a chance at the king, but now you fuckers are useless.
I'm pretty sure the king probably wouldn't be that happy if, like, he hears of this great performance and the performance left town before he could see it.
Squire!
Please note, I'm the most charismatic one.
Yeah. I also don't think he'd be too happy to be assassinated by people who aren't from this town.
Oh my god, not this again!
Come on, think about it. It's poetic, isn't it? The king on his birthday being assassinated. It's just the perfect time. So, no. Especially today. No.
If we were assassins, we wouldn't have been able to get into the gate, right?
Honestly, those two guards let anyone in. They've honestly never denied anyone. I honestly don't know why we have a gate.
Yeah, they were wondering about the gate. They were wondering about why you guys had a gate too.
Honestly, we need to replace them, but no one else is willing to take the damn job. It's so boring. I used to work the gate. Nothing happened. Ever. Not one attack. There's no one around here. It's literally Flatlands. No one is here. So with the fact that a bunch of adventurers just come out of nowhere, it's a tiny bit suspicious. It could be from Lockwell, for all we know.
What the fuck?
Is that the fucking name of the other place? I have no idea.
Where's Lockwell?
Is that actually the name of the place, Lockwell?
Am I right? I think it was, yeah. I ask him, where's Lockwell?
It is Lackwiss.
Lackwiss. Where's Lackwiss?
Macris is the opposing city to the west.
Oh, right. East.
I don't fucking know. Directions.
Directly that way.
Directly that way.
Alright.
There's still bad blood in the air. Despite the amount of nothing that goes on in this place, there still could be attempts.
Question. Why do you want to take each other's land when there's plenty of other land you can just expand into?
We've expanded all we can. There's only so much land around here, and we need more resources. We need the other people's lands for resources.
There's like 2 hours worth of land that way at the crossroads.
That's all farmland.
No, you said it was just barren flatland.
We turn it into farmland.
Tell you what. What if we help you guys out with your Lackwis problem?
How so?
So, you say that you want to expand into their land, correct?
Yes.
What if we help you with that? We are fair.
It's not my place to make any deals.
Exactly. I honestly don't like how this conversation is going.
You let us talk to the king, and we deal with him. Or your military advisor. I don't give a fuck. We just want to talk to people.
Give us someone important to talk to.
And how do I know you're not wasting my time with all this?
Because does it look like we're wasting your time?
I see an old man with ghosts and a fucking elemental in a birdcage, a shady-looking man in a cloak, a knight, and a female that's... nothing about her. Just pretty normal. Yeah, you look like you're wasting my time.
Haven't you been wasting your whole time here waiting for someone to attack, though?
We're not actively waiting on people to attack, it's just that nothing's happened. We don't want war.
But you want something to happen so that you can just do something else, right?
Would be the worst thing, but I'm not the person to start a war.
Neither are we.
If the king learns I sent people to attack Lackwis, what do you think happens to me?
It depends on our success. If we're successful, the king is like, congratulations, no name guard. You're now my personal bodyguard.
By the way, what is your name?
My name?
Yes.
My name is insert name here.
Alright, and yours? I asked the other guard.
Insert name here.
Insert name here too.
Are you two twins?
I don't fucking make names for them. Are you kidding me? They're just fucking people.
Alright, so, insert name here.
Fuck off.
How about you ask your king real quick? He's inside, correct?
And leave my post.
Fair enough.
Send a carrier, bitch.
Have someone who isn't your post.
There's no one else here. Everyone else is inside. Making very unreasonable demands.
Holy
what
Jesus.
Are people doing inside?
Celebrating.
You know what? Let's talk about this realistically.
And you guys are stuck out here, not protecting your king, while everyone is out, while everyone else is inside, and any one of them could possibly be an assassin, right?
That's
not
true.
We're out here keeping out the riffraff, like you, who are potential assassins. So yes, I'd say we're defending our king fairly well.
How do you know there isn't an assassin already in the party room?
The guards inside will take care of that, and we haven't let anyone in who isn't trustworthy already. So unless there's a coup, there's nothing gonna happen. Unless
a coup?
You in. A coup! A coup! Damn it!
You realize your guard friends inside are probably just getting...
I mixed up really coup and coup de grace. Fuck.
Anyway, back to what I was saying. You realize your guard buddies in there are probably drinking booze, right?
Probably not. They're on duty.
They're on duty in a party. They're not... Trust me, they're going to be drinking in some form or another.
No, they're not. That's not logical in any way.
Excuse him for a moment. So, tell us a way... We can talk to the king.
Letter, probably. It's a good one.
I'll write one now. I write out a letter with our proposal of, like, hey, we would like to take out Lacquis. And the proceedings to that. And I hand him the letter.
So, he reads it. So, you're telling me you're asking the king to trust a random band of ragtag weirdos to assassinate Lacquis?
I mean...
Is that the name of the king?
No, it's just a town. Like, I assume you're gonna kill everybody.
I mean, subjugate them at least, yes.
And if this should fail, what happens to the king? He gets publicly ridiculed for having attacked another town. Even if there is bad blood, there's been no attacks. We do maintain a relation somewhat.
Here's how I see
it. Then tell me, why would they ruin that relationship with an assassin? Why would they ruin it?
If they were going to assassinate, they would try, but no one's ever tried or failed, or no one's ever tried or succeeded.
Alright.
Then why would they try now when everything's fine?
I'm sorry, have we met? Hello, I'm the guard here. Who are you?
Squire, please.
Don't believe I've met.
I'm sorry.
Did I just roll reversal him?
I'm sorry for his rudeness. He's a squire. He's kind of new to this whole business.
I've never met you in my life. Good day. This, I believe, is the first time we're seeing each other. Hi, I'm the guard who is not letting you in. You should be the people probably getting out of town. Because I don't know who the fuck you are.
Alright, here's how I see it. Nobody has to know that we are the king's, you know...
Envoys?
Yes. Until...
Literally wrote a letter with your proposal. You have physical evidence.
Until...
He rips up the letter.
You gonna hand it to them?
You can burn it.
He rips it up.
Yeah. Until we successfully take care of Lacquis.
I'm a bit baffled.
Alright, so here's
how
I see
it. I mean, your logic and everything.
Here's how
you're expecting me to trust you with the assassination of the enemy king.
Here's how I see it. It's a win-win situation for you. Alright?
It's not!
It is, because we go there, let's say we die, alright? Nobody knows that we are part of the king's envoy. We don't tell anyone. Simple. We go there, we win, and we successfully take down the other town. Your king has now taken over the other town successfully. So if we win or lose, it ends up good for the king.
How did you get to town, perchance? Did you take the main road?
Yes. Why?
Yeah.
You were probably seen coming this way then. The roads are monitored.
By who?
By who? By who or what monitors these damn roads?
Patrols! There's patrols on both sides. Did you not see them?
No.
Nope, not particularly.
Were there actual patrols?
Like, you didn't see a patrol.
I'm asking you, Iggy. Were there?
Yeah,
now
there's
that you
patrols
mentioned,
on the road.
We did see dead people.
What?
Yeah.
That was a bit further back.
That was earlier on. I stole all their armor, didn't I?
You didn't. I don't think so.
I remember stealing all their swords. I know that. I got like 8 or something swords.
I don't recall.
I recall. Right, Nick?
I don't remember. It's been a while.
Hold on a second.
If you've uploaded the episode, then I should be there.
Hold on a second.
All right.
Goes inside, and he goes to talk to somebody. About 5 minutes pass, and he comes back out. It seems Squad 1 Patrol has not come back in since this morning. If what you're saying is true, then there was an attack on our patrolman, which has never happened before. How many bodies were there?
We tell them the amount. Fuck it. Too tired of this. We don't need another.
There was 8 or 9, exactly. I think.
That's more than double of our patrol. That almost makes no sense.
There were two different colors of shields, right?
I believe so.
Weren't there red and blue shields there? I'm assuming that's what their colors are.
Yes, they were like basically red and blue.
Alright.
It's like two opposing colors. Do you have anything from one of the bodies that could identify them?
Apparently,
I pull out eight swords.
These insignias on the hilts are definitely of both of the towns. So, two patrols killed each other. Or was it something else? Alright. At the very least, you've proven that you're not with the enemy somewhat. For now, kind of. The fact that you have both of these means you're not on either side, at least in my eyes. You can see the king, but don't expect anything.
Thank you.
And expect to be heavily, heavily fucking attacked if you do anything suspicious.
Of course.
You got All it. Right. I put the swords back in my clothing.
Alright. So you go inside. The guards pass, they let you inside and go in. There's not actually a map for this, because why would I make a map for this shit?
Because there could be a battle?
It's semi-important.
Don't worry about it. Anyway, you go inside, and the first room you see is just a giant fucking hall with a bunch of food on a long table and several noblemen eating and laughing and drinking wine. You see about eight guards lining the walls with pikes. And at the very back of the room, at the head of the table, you see the royal family, being a king and a queen, a small young prince.
Okay, I just want to pause for a moment. Those guards are very bad at their job because they saw me pull out eight swords, put all those swords back into my clothing, and then walk right past them.
I mean, it's not like evidence you can use eight swords at a time.
But still.
Evidence of what you're trying to claim anyway.
There's guards in here anyways. Like, you're going to pull out a sword, you're going to have a bad time.
Pretty much.
I know, but I'm just saying.
So you come in, and you're stopped by a guard, and it's like, what's your business?
It's your business.
Not quite what I expected in a response. Why are you here?
We were sent in by the guy who's outside the door.
What?
Well, we found two... We found your patrol.
We found
both
of
you... We're here to speak with the king.
Yeah, we're here to speak with the king, motherfucker.
The king is currently celebrating his 42nd birthday.
We have a matter of urgent...
Squire?
Urgent.
Squire, we can wait until the celebrations have concluded. Then we can talk to him. It's a common
celebrations
courtesy.
Will be done tomorrow.
Oh. Well, tonight's...
You don't just have a birthday for fucking half an hour, motherfucker.
Tonight's festivities, then. When they conclude, we'll talk to him.
You realize they're probably going to end in the morning, right?
We can wait. Easy.
All right. Then I'll have to ask you to leave until then.
Ah, dude, it was hard enough to get in here. Are you kidding me?
We have information concerning one of your patrols and a patrol of... whatever the left city was called again.
Lacris.
Lacris, right. Of one of your patrols and one of the patrols of Lacris killing each other.
Killing? Trolls have never had attacks in 50 years.
I pull out the sword from both of their towns.
Don't pull them all the way out, just show them the hilts.
That's what I'm doing.
Alright, just making sure.
Alright, come with me.
I put the sword back in.
Just one of you.
I'm the most charismatic.
But you're not the best at speaking, to be honest. Oh. Will you allow me and my squire to attend, or...
One.
One? Well,
I think...
Can't just send him alone, so you should go.
Should we rock, paper, scissors it?
Oh, God.
Fuck that. We're gonna just send, Just gonna send Nick.
Yeah, I'll go.
Actually, no, we're not gonna send Nick. We're gonna fucking send. We're gonna send friggin' Stan. Stan probably has our best interests in mind.
What do you?
Price to steal from the king's pockets.
That will not end well.
I was planning on stealing food from the table.
Oh my god. Do that out here then. Yes.
No one. All right. Let's see.
Look, you're at the entrance to the room. Like you're being held at the door to the room. So the food's a little bit in.
Ah, fucking take me. God damn it. No one else is gonna. No one else is fit for this fucking.
I got this covered. Look.
Pick one or leave.
Have Matchy do it.
Look, I have. Look, all right. I have my ghost with me. All right. If anything happens, I can just quickly send one to you, and then we're good. Simple.
Or you could just send the ghost with me, and everything will be fine.
Yeah, but then I won't be able to just, like, super control them, you know? Like, I kind of want them to be in my line of sight, not just
OMG, can't you just send
somewhere.
All of us and just have us heavily guarded or whatever?
No! One!
Look, I got this covered, alright?
Just go.
I start.
Alright, you sending Nick?
I start.
Alright.
I start walking.
You gonna
take
the swords with you?
Shit. You're right. I'll take two of them.
Alright, you take one of each, I assume.
Yeah.
And you start. The guard takes them and he starts walking upward in the middle of the aisle.
Matchy, get me some food, okay?
Sure. And I look at him puzzlingly.
Sure. The guard walks you up to the king. He's like, who is this?
Hello, my good sir. My name is Matchy. It's nice to meet you. Happy birthday.
Why are you here right now? In the middle of my 42nd birthday.
Not in the middle, it's 6 o'clock, actually.
I heard that.
You heard that? I'm not even here to hear your conversation. Hear that?
It's a fucking room. It's probably echoey. It's echoey.
But there's also a ton of other people just chatting, which will drown out immediately.
He's got good ears.
He's 42.
Good ears!
Then he should have been able to hear our whole conversation at the door.
My head hurts, goddamn. I know the feeling. I have to fucking do all this shit.
I tell him, I'm afraid it's not with the best of news. And I show him the hilts of the swords.
Where did you get those?
I found them on the way here at the crossroads between this town and Blackwiss. There were, I believe, 8 guards, all dead on the ground. 4 from Blackwiss and 4 from here, I presume.
Huh. This is troubling news, to say the least. Any indication of what happened?
It seems as though there was an act of aggression on one side or the other. I'm going to assume it was Blackwiss who attacked your people. And
are any proof of that?
No, not that I know of. And it seems as though both were killed in combat. Both sides, I mean.
I guess I should describe what the king looks like.
Sure, do it.
King's a very old-looking man for 42. It looks like you see the back of his fucking behind where he's sitting. You see a bunch of war trophies, despite not ever being at war. He's got like odd plaques of arms and odd sigils and swords. He seems very proud of his position. He's wearing a gold necklace with a key on it, and fairly fat.
All right.
Got a sweet mustache as well.
Is his wife hot?
Wife's average. Probably just there because of royal blood.
Alright.
Are you fucking kidding me? Is his wife hot? What the fuck is wrong?
Not Ray's mom.
Aw, damn it. Look, these are things
is
I need to know, alright?
No, it's not.
Fine, he looks like Gandalf.
Gandalf the White or Gandalf the Grey?
Both.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, I like Grey.
I like Grey.
So, where were we in the conversation?
He's fucking asking you if there's any proof of which side initiated the attack. You said no. This is troubling.
Very.
If Lackless knows about this, then they'll assume we attacked, and vice versa. Now, say we simply fortify our defenses and hope this just passes.
But what if it does not?
That's why we fortify defenses.
But who knows when they could come? I say, I have with me a group of fairly competent fighters. I gesture over to them. And we would like...
Who do you serve?
Huh?
What are your accolades? Who do you serve?
Who do we... Sorry, say again.
No one anyway. No one
what
anyway.
Are your accolades? Who do you serve?
I don't know what accolades...
It's basically asking, what have you accomplished... Like, what accomplishments have been recognized by, like, a fucking company, and who do you serve?
At this moment, we currently serve no one, hoping to be you in the future, and in the past, we have defeated a stone golem and completed a total of, I believe, 6 different quests, including the defeat of a frost giant and the obtaining of magical items.
Wait, what the fuck?
Strong claims, there's nothing to back them up.
I show him the tome.
It's
took
a
this
book.
From Yeti.
I open it up. This is one of the magical items we have attained. Acquired.
It's blank.
Yes, well, it has magical properties. Would you happen to have one like it? I hear they're somewhat rare.
It's a book. There's a library in my quarters with a lot of books with actual words.
Yes, but any...
I'd highly call that... highly not call that magical.
But are any blank like this?
No. Typically, books have words. I don't know what passes as magic from where you come from, but that looks like a blank book.
Wait, isn't my choker still, emanating light?
Yeah, that's the thing.
Alright, I show him that then. Another magical item.
So you have equipment with a lesser charm on it.
What does
you could buy that at
ye
old dollar store.
Touche.
Besides all this... I can't confirm your warriors are competent, so I can't confirm anything you've done, and so far your evidence is lacking.
Have him prove us against, like, one of his warriors or something.
No, that's too easy. Or too...
Listen.
Cliched.
Well, it's time
I'm
for me
I'm not gonna
to
be
do...
the one to incite
time
war.
It's time for me to do something super cool. Are you guys ready for
oh,
this?
Oh, boy.
Oh, please don't.
Well,
oh, please, yes. Nope, I'm doing stuff, fuck you, Nick. Time for sword floating magic.
Oh
yeah,
my
God. This
damn.
Can't go wrong, it never goes wrong, it always ends up for the best of the group. Woo!
I don't suggest doing anything with the sword because there's currently, like,
oh
my guards
God.
Staring at us.
Chris,
so they can't
why?
Do anything.
He can
oh,
do it!
It's
his ability.
Not my sword. It's not my sword.
It's Scap.
It's Scap. Sorry.
But there's 20 guards staring at us.
Well, that'll be your problem.
Well, technically speaking, there's only 8.
That'll be your problem. You're not gonna...
And then there's all the other guards in the room.
That's 8 guards. There's 8 guards in the room.
Okay. I'm going to tell what I'm gonna do, right? You know?
Gaming Ancient Ninja, you came in... At basically the wrong point. If you had said that, like, fucking episode 1, you'd be right. They tried to burn down fucking everything. This
what?
Is literally, like, you should have seen the last game. and the game before that, burned down everything. He said fucking burned down the hall accidentally.
I'm the only one with a moral conscience.
Seth, Seraph of One, magic missile to the
I have a moral conscience, it's just mine has to be dipped, mine's just dipped horribly in evil.
Seraph of One, you must be new, because you're not a mod.
Not an evil, chaos.
Stab the king with the floaty sword. Stop helping him!
Stop!
I'm not gonna do that, that's horrible.
You're gonna stab me with it, aren't you?
Oh, no, that's where you stop, but killing your fucking teammate, no.
Oh, I could stab you! Huh.
You could.
I honestly gave a better thing. You honestly gave me a better idea than what I was going to do. Magical sword.
What are you doing, Chris?
Oh, the magical swords. Well, it's gonna try. It's gonna float. It's gonna float towards Nick.
Alright. So
it's on the complete opposite side of the room.
Chris, you're gonna roll a d20 plus 12.
Yeah.
And you're gonna need, I'd say, a 22 to get out of no, a 20 to get out of scap. Right?
I have to do slash roll d20. That's a thing. It's been a
slash
while.
Slash r d20 plus 12. Get a simple right, 20 to get out of scap's fucking scabbard.
Plus slash r d20 plus 12.
Yes.
Fucking working.
You know what you can do? There's a fuck. I don't know if you can see it, but there's an icon on the left that's the D20. You can do it through there, which is a basic roller.
Oh my god.
Well, I didn't do it. That's okay. I just missed.
Plus,
you guys are lucky. God. You guys are lucky.
You just add 12 to that, and fucking, yeah, you didn't get it. So, yeah.
Does it not even get out of the scab?
It does not get out of the scab, but he does not able to float it.
Well.
Alright.
Night, metal. Mega metal. Good night.
Night, dude.
Alright, so nothing happens there. Conversation continues.
Where are we again?
Yeah, I'm about to ask the same thing. Fucking... you're trying to convince the king to do something, but he's not very impressed with what you've shown him so far.
Right.
He seems intent on just being defensive.
Give me a second.
Second given. Second over.
Give me like 20 seconds.
Have us play a simple game of capture the flag and we'll be super defensive.
What?
I was making a joke.
Yeah, you kind of guessed. And...
So, how long have you wanted... Laquis's land.
Laquis. Both kingdoms desire each other's kingdom, but it's not the most pressing matter. Survival is generally the first.
Yes, but
what kind of king am I to fucking throw the safety of my people for an off?
Wait, how long do I have to wait to do sword shit again?
I'd say
a while.
Just a bit. We'll know when. It's not like a set time, but...
Okay, well, if it can happen in this fight... if it can happen... Well, not this fight. If it can happen in this talk, tell me. If not, well, whatever.
Not this conversation, no.
Okay.
So, why would you want to only survive? Wouldn't you want to thrive instead? Especially for your... It is a son, right? Not a daughter.
It is a son.
Wouldn't you want to make a better kingdom for your son to one day take over?
Arrogant words from a man who doesn't know tactics.
True. And yet not.
Tell him about... On your mind.
You have no claim to anything. No proof. And all you've shown me is that some of my men have died to something we don't know. It could have been the enemy, it could have been something else. Maybe it was a bear.
Yes, but could one
all
bear...
All I see here is that we're not equipped to fight.
But yet me and my allies are.
And you've shown me no proof that you are able to fight.
How about this?
Show me a blank book.
Our proof...
Color me impressed.
Our proof will be the taking over of Lachlis.
And once they realize the other people sent mercenaries to attack their town, you think they're going to take that sitting down?
Yes, but here's the thing. We will go to them peacefully, like we have here. And we will show them the same... thing.
Evidence.
Like, yes, evidence. And we will get in easily. At that point, we will successfully infiltrate them and take them out. Simple.
We're talking to them.
And your plan to do anything? So you're saying your plan is to die?
Our plan is to win.
Tell them we were able to get a full frontal attack.
Not full frontal, though. Because we will be
your
able to...
Your plan is to walk into the king's chamber, show him your evidence, and stab him.
Yes.
I mean, if we really want to do that to you,
we're here already with you.
Do you not see how easy it was for us to get into here? We could do the same with Lachlis.
You think you could take me?
Of course not.
Possible.
You are the king,
then
after all.
What makes you think you could take them?
Because I have no respect for the people of Lachlis. You, however, I have great respect for.
Empty words.
True. And yet not. I've seen the town you've created here. It's quite peaceful and nice.
I can't ignore the death of my men, and I'm very sure the town of Lachlis can't ignore the death of theirs either. Something will happen. Right now, it's a celebration. Why don't we talk tomorrow?
Fair enough. I will see any specific time you'd like to meet, or something of that sort.
Come in the morning. We'll talk it over.
Okay. I will...
By then, Lachlis will probably be preparing their move as well.
Alright then. I will speak with you again then. I bow, walk out. And I try to filch, like, an apple or something.
That's gonna be a roll. Why not?
That's mean. Well, he's not gonna let you back in and steal an apple. Maybe just ask him for it, you dumb shit. Just fucking ask him. Hey, can I have an apple?
You gonna commit to this or what?
What's my dex?
If you recall, you have apples on your beds.
Don't you can ruin our chance. You can ruin our chances of being stealing apples.
True.
It's a party. The apples are technically free.
Plus, it'll make you look like more of an asshole.
It will.
I'm doing it.
Fine.
God, Nick.
It's a celebration. Now fuck off.
Plus 15, right?
D20 plus 15, yes. Basically, you get a fucking 20.
Oh, wait, no, I'm good.
You didn't eat that much, it's just a fucking apple.
True.
Alright, you took an apple, no one fucking notices. If anyone did notice, they don't give a singular fuck.
Sweet, I did it.
You walk out.
Yeah.
God damn it.
I give the apple to Stan.
Thanks, Matchy.
Uh-huh.
I immediately begin eating it.
And now you're an asshole. Critical fail, you end up smacking your face into the table. Alright, so what's your plan now? Chris, you still have all the room keys.
Well, I have all the room keys. All the rooms look the same, right?
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, alright, I take them to the two rooms that are together. I say, this one's mine. This one is... What the fuck is Nick's character's name?
Matchy.
This is Matchy. You owe me 15 gold, Matchy. And right. Down the hall...
is this one. It's over here.
Down the hall here is Stan's room. Stan, you also owe me 15 gold, because that's how much these rooms bloody cost. So whenever you like to pay me back for that, that would be fucking great. But here are our rooms.
I give him the 15.
Here,
And here's then, your right. keys. Here's your keys. All right. And you, Scap. Which of the two guys are you gonna sleep with?
Whoever will tolerate my presence.
Scap with me.
I'm really not picky.
Sure.
I really just want this gold out of my boots.
Yes, I will take care of that
I'll
for you.
I'll take it. I said it first.
No, you.
I
remember. I have 7 gold total. You have everything else.
I know. I'm covering. I'll cover that rest of the 8 gold for you.
Taking loans out already.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm broke again.
Yep.
All right. So I gain 30 gold back. It's nice.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. All right. Well, I say we retire for the night and set forth tomorrow to victory.
Yeah.
So I take the apple from my bed and add it to my inventory.
So, how exactly does any of this help us? So, I'm very unclear on this.
Look, the tome is somewhere here. It's probably in one of the king's libraries. So, if we defeat Lakwis successfully or whatever, we can,
Well, it could be in Lakwis's libraries.
I know, but when we defeat Lakwis, we'll be able to take it from their library. Or, for instance, if we... And we could also, like, ask to see this king's library as well. Once we defeat Lakwis, of course.
Ah. I see. Alright. That could work.
Very much so. And snooze.
Alright. And your ghosts are dead.
Aww.
Can you remind me what's in our inn rooms?
Your inn rooms are basically just a bed, an apple, a toilet, the works.
So
a nice window
he...
with a nice view out of the flatlands.
So who is Scap going with?
Scap's going with Machi. Any objections? Any concerns? Any complaints?
No.
I don't care.
So you all go to sleep. Is that correct?
I'm assuming they're going to lock their bedroom doors, right?
Probably.
Well, no late night thieving for me.
I mean, you could go to one of the other rooms if you really wanted. Or to a house.
I mean, you don't really have a lock pick or anything, so... Anyway, other actions before you go to sleep?
I take the gold out of Scap.
Praise the sun, thank you.
No problem, anytime.
Right, well, since I don't sleep, I shall retire to this window.
Yes, the window.
Look for bunnies and deer, why not?
Oh, the window? Okay. I'm going to make note of his location.
Ooh.
You're actually writing down notes?
No, mentally. Tape it by.
Alright. End day? Everyone good with that?
Yep.
Yeah. Now it's tomorrow.
Alright, well. During... I don't want to do this.
You just cut out.
Alright, you know what? Fine. Next morning. You guys wake up in your beds.
Wait. Healing?
Scaps... Oh, yeah, I guess you do heal. There. Roll a D... Let's leave this up to rolls, why don't we? Because that's more fun. Roll a D3.
Hey.
If you're hurt, anyway.
Yeah.
All right. Nickel heal 3, so he's back up to 12.
My max is
16,
right? 19, yeah.
I'm already at max health.
So you don't need to roll. I don't know if Scap's hurt. Scap is hurt. So you rolled 3.
I need
Chris,
to roll.
You need to heal 2.
How much should I roll? What's it? D3?
D3.
Is it going to be a 2?
Are you hurt, Chris?
I am hurt. He is.
You could be close to full if you get this critically correct.
I can't physically roll.
I can roll for you, or... / R / D whatever. D3.
Base would have fucking
helped.
Oh,
look at 2.
A 1. Okay, you're at 14 of 17.
Okay.
And that's all the healing for today. Woo!
Yay!
All
just
right.
So you know, just so you know, I steal the bed sheets.
Okay, sure.
I now have bed sheets in my inventory, and I'm going to steal the bed sheets from their rooms, too.
Well, you're only in your room. I imagine they would probably lock the door behind them. Anyway.
Any other rooms, I showed you them.
Anyway,
by the time you stole the sheets, up. He would have kicked you.
New day, new possibilities, new adventures. What's your course of action?
Go back to the castle? The house, the mansion king. Thing?
Pretty like this,
yeah.
Like,
yeah,
quarters.
We can all right. Go do that.
So, you all go outside. Skep recounts his amazing stories of watching... what the fuck is that?
You moved the end sign.
Why is it on the object screen?
Because, Ian made it.
I wrote it when we got here so we knew where was what.
It's gone now. Fucking Skep's recounting all the deer and birds and mysterious red lights he saw.
Oh, you saw red lights? Night.
Yes, night. It's quite peculiar. Around the sun rising up, there was an odd light in the distance, so it could have just been a campfire.
Do we know what the allegiance of this town is? Is it red or blue?
It's just, they're just two opposing colors. It really doesn't matter.
No, but he saw red knights. Is it, do we know this town?
This place would probably be blue.
Okay, no, just making, like, I mean, that's kind of important. Two opposing colors, but there are red knights. Kind of gotta.
Yeah, so.
Did he say night or light?
Light. There was a red light around dawn.
Fucking
it could have just been a campfire, though. I highly doubt it was anything. So as you're making your way out, the whole town's pretty excited. They're, like, just going around, and they seem to be very uppity, very energetic. So what do you want to do?
Go see the king.
King.
All right. Make your way to the king. Go up out there. The guards stop you. Like, oi.
We're the same ones from
What's
yesterday. King here? Wanted. To, we're the same ones from yesterday. King wanted to talk to us.
What? Gone daft? I don't know who the hell you are.
Oh my god! Are you a different guard?
Same guards. We hasn't been any travelers here in months.
But perchance is today the king's birthday.
Is it Groundhog?
Yes.
Fuck.
It's Groundhog Day.
Fuck.
Pretty sure everyone knows that.
The red day, the red light was like a time portal or whatever.
There's nothing confirming nor denying that.
I'm just gonna ask them what the date is.
We don't know what yesterday
they say
was.
The date was the same. Let's just assume you keep track of the date. The date was the same date as yesterday for you.
Okay, so the day just repeated itself.
What?
So the day just repeated itself.
I'm talking to the guard. Guard's like, what the hell are you talking about?
No, I'm talking to myself. I'm talking to myself, like real life talking to myself.
Oh, okay.
Wait,
so the day repeated itself. But this time we're here in the morning instead of the afternoon, because we got here at 6 yesterday.
So do we still have all our money? Do we still have all our stuff from yesterday? Did all that happen?
Like all the gold and such?
Are you asking in character or out? Because I can't answer
out
that
of character. Out of
I can't
character.
Answer that.
How? Why can't you answer? You can't answer that our inventory stayed the same? Like, come on.
I was like, talking character, you're not fine, whatever. No. You don't have anything you had yesterday. The swords are gone, the money's gone, the apples are gone.
I still have the swords because I got those before. Wait.
Wanna look, motherfucker? Your inventory is down 8 swords.
Wait, I'm just thinking now. I got the swords before we went into the town. What time did we actually see the dead people?
You saw the dead people around, I'd say, 1 o'clock. Maybe even 2 o'clock.
Afternoon?
No, 2 o'clock. It would have been around 2 o'clock.
Alright, so it's like, what time is it?
Right now, it's 10 a.m. Bright and early.
10 a.m. Alright, well, we're sure it's the we're still sure it's the previous day. In town. Alright. Well, we're gonna have to somehow prove our way back.
We can't go through the whole conversation again because I don't have the swords on me now.
Technically
my swords are in a pocket dimension, so...
Want to look for those swords in that pocket dimension? Because I'm pretty sure those swords aren't in that pocket dimension right now. Okay. Quite a conundrum, isn't it?
Okay. One, they're not in there. Two, they're in there. Oh, look, they're in there.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I just flipped a coin. One was heads, and if it was heads, it wasn't there. And if it was tails, it was there. And look, I got tails.
Alright, I forgot that critically important rule in 4th edition. If the player makes a fucking head versus tails roll, he can totally change the course of the story. On a whim.
But yeah, no, that's not...
No.
Now I don't have my my 8 swords.
No, they're gone. You don't know how they're gone. You don't even know how they would be gone. They were in a pocket dimension, so that's super fucking weird, isn't it? Nick, you're very quiet right now. What's up with you?
I'm thinking. Alright. Of possibilities we could do.
I'm going to ask Scrap to take us to where he saw the light.
The light was in the distance. I can't pinpoint exactly where, but it was back towards Lapwas. Lapwas? Even I can't say it fucking right. Fuck that name.
Oh, wait a minute. Let's contact Gizbit real quick.
Alright, you can do that.
I take out the Gizbit phone.
I think Nick had it, but sure. You contact Gizbit.
I'm pretty sure I have it because if I remember correctly, my inventory has some sort of black rock in it. And if I remember correctly, the phone was black.
Wow, African-American. Anyway, yeah, fine. You contact Gizmit. Hi, what's up? That's not the right voice.
What's today's date?
Today's date? Why?
I think we're stuck in a time loop. Yep. And I need to make sure.
Like, let's do the time loop again, or like Groundhog Day.
Groundhog Day.
How the fuck would you know about Groundhog Day? How the fuck would any of us know about Groundhog
Day? Like,
very popular fucking theater movie. Theater. Show.
Alright, so situation. Play. That's the word. Situation. We went to sleep in a different place, and everyone... It seems like everyone's memory...
You're gonna keep talking over each other, motherfuckers! What are you doing?
It seems like... Alright, so... It seems like our body's positions didn't get reset, but any items we acquired, or...
What about the swords you guys got yesterday?
Yeah, I was about to ask.
What? Oh, wait, the swords you guys got, you still have those.
Okay, so anything after we came out.
Okay, so it must have been after noon or something. Because if I got the swords at 1, and we got out of the cave at, like, 1-ish, and you got the swords at, like, possibly before noon, then it would be at noon that the Groundhog Day
Us the date, please.
He says the date that would have been after you left. Like, nothing happened. Like, the date's normal for him.
Alright.
Okay, so we're stuck in a time loop.
Wait. You're telling me the date's different there?
It's the same day as it was yesterday. So, yes.
Huh. Well, it's not entirely impossible that this is the tome's doing.
Light you saw.
Looks like you guys are going to have to figure this out in a day. Or, you know, whatever a day is equivalent there. You're just going to have to figure this out in a go. Whatever. Sounds annoying. I'm glad I'm not doing it. Go fuck yourselves.
Alright, so I say...
Just get it done.
I say we wait till nightfall, kill somebody, and then wake up the next day and see if they're still alive.
Sure. I'm just gonna say no to that.
Also, yes. To that
you hang up on Gizbeater, is he still in this?
No, all right. Yeah.
All
right.
Scap, what's your input on this?
I've honestly never encountered anything like this. This is far more interesting than what we were doing yesterday. Holy shit.
Gizbit, question. Do you have a Gizbit, do you have a second communicator we can use so we can talk to each other? Because I has an amazing idea. Two of us will go to the other city. Two of us will stay here and we'll communicate and tell what's going on with each other through the communicator you give us.
Well, there's only one communicator, first off. Even if I had another, they only connect to this area up here. You couldn't connect to two of them together.
Yeah, we tell you what we learn, and then you tell them what we told you.
Oh god, that's annoying. But no, there isn't another one. Not yet. I could make another, but that would take a few days.
Seeing as we're stuck in the same day, I think it could work.
Well, I'll get working on that, but don't expect anything soon.
Got it.
What if it was his voice? I know this is not his voice, but...
It was close to that.
You can check the VOD.
I'm not doing that right now. Anyway. This is more than likely the tome's doing. If the tome is already having an outward effect of this, it's probably very volatile and dangerous. It's in your best interest to find this as fast as possible before anything else happens.
Okay, which out of the two of us, which out of the four of us are the two fastest? Out of speed wise.
I think that'd be a dex thing. That'd technically be you. And
the two of us, because like two of us can run to the other city and the other.
You're the highest. Scap and Nick are tied at 15.
So me and Scrap are the fastest.
What's this? Raiho 21. Hi man, nice game. I'm playing for SNES and the Sun. What?
I didn't understand either.
Well, you're new here, so why?
I think he means Seventh Saga. Oh, that's Saga, not Sega.
Irrelevant right now, anyway, so...
Yeah.
What's your plan?
Okay, we have the two fastest people, which would be me and whoever is the second fastest. We run
or Nick.
Okay, we run over to the other city, see what's going on there. And basically have two different D&D games at the same time. But we do that normally.
That's not two different D&D games. That's one D&D game done properly. That's a brilliant Nick.
Well, hold on. Look at it this way. We know there's a tome in either one of the towns. Alright? It's probably in the Royal Treasury. For the most part, might be in the Royal Library, or it's somewhere around town. The only way we can know if it's in the Royal Library, though, we break in. And breaking in's gonna be hard, though, because we need to get in there first. So, I say, we allow the day to reset, and then we enact the first day we came here. Because maybe things will happen the same way.
I mean, right now it's basically the start. Time really hasn't moved. It's the start of the day. I don't know why you would restart the day.
Well, no, because we've already talked to the guard and technically fucked up. Today is an entire new possibility.
All right, do what you do. I'm just here to tell you what's happening.
So I'm just
and occasionally fuck you over.
So as I was saying, have me and. Either Matchy or Scrap go over to the other city and go and see what's going on there.
You can do that.
Because since we're the fastest, we can get over there fairly quickly.
It's still... I'd say if you're running, about an hour to get to the crossroads and probably another hour to get to the other city.
Yeah, that's not too long. We might even see the patrols that killed each other. We could see what happens. We can see what happens with the patrol.
Or we could kill them ourselves.
How about no?
No, if we kill them ourselves, we definitely prove the allegiance. If we kill Akisa's town, kind of definitely prove allegiance to this town.
But we'd also prove that we're enemies of themselves since we killed their own soldiers.
No, no, no. We're not going to kill
their own soldiers. We kill one side's soldiers and then go to the other side's town.
Like, we see the fight happen, then we jump in and protect whoever. If the people are still alive, anyway. If they're not just dead on the ground. Still.
How about we just go back to the crossroads and see what happens?
Sure.
Alright, you two go do that. Me and Scap will fuck around in town.
Alright.
I thought Scrap was coming with me.
I mean, me and him are tied to speed, so.
Who's going where and what's doing what?
Well, we need at least one charismatic person here because I'm the highest out of charisma and Machi has the second highest charisma, right?
Yeah, I don't know. Nick's charisma is fucking 9.
What's Chaos's?
4, something like that. 6. No, wait, it's fucking 10.
What's Scrap's?
10.
Yeah, I'll take Scrap.
Why not me? Like,
all right.
I would rather have 2 people with medium charisma be together than a person.
When did charisma become the deciding factor? Holy shit!
Well, that's what he's trying to argue. Like, oh, the charisma, it has to be one of each and either whatever. I think.
Hey, Nick, rock paper scissors now.
Oh my God. You know, this game probably wouldn't be half as long if we just fucking decided on shit.
Stan, we're going right, together. Fuck. You're my squire, let's go.
Scap will save me. We'll do fuck if I know what
I'm. Fine, I take the lead though. I start running.
Sounds good. I run after him.
Alright. Fucking.
Alright.
So they're Scap. Doing that. What are you doing, Chris?
Well, I'm gonna talk to Scap real quick.
Yes.
Okay. Alright, Scap, how much can I trust you?
Decently?
Alright, how much would I need to pay you to silence Matchy Eternity?
I'm sorry?
But never mind.
Well, all right then. Nothing done. Nothing hurts. We're all good. All
right. Well, okay. Well, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna see if we can find any like mercenaries or somewhere in this town. That'd be cool. Mercenaries are cool.
Judging by the crowd we drew yesterday, I think we saw mostly everybody. There wasn't any rugged people that weren't already aligned to the king here. And bribing one of them to come with us is probably a feeble feat. I do quite think we're on our own here.
So annoying. Alright. What's your price? How much could I buy you for? To do generally what I tell you to.
I generally don't have a use for money. But you did give me my sword, so... Oh, wait, that was Matchy. Never mind.
Yo.
Yeah, but it was mine before his, so...
Well, you indirectly gave me my sword. You're the one who suggested I come, and so far that's proven fruitful. I'm not really at a price, but I could do a favor.
I don't think he'll do this favor, though.
Oh, come now, it can't be that bad.
I don't know. It is that bad, but we'll see.
I'm listening.
Oh, yeah, okay. I need you to kill a person.
Oh, well, that's not too far out of my line of work. I was originally a guardsman. I did guard a cave.
What would you say if that person happened to be in our party?
Well, I
typically don't like to take advantage of the trust others have in me. And everyone's been so nice.
I believe he took advantage.
Hmm? How so?
I remember our last party member. How they
I've heard the story from you, yes.
I believe he may have been behind it.
But he was the one to stab him through, was he not?
I was the one who's to stab him through, but only after he told me so.
Huh. Anything else to accuse Mr. Machi of treason, of all things. And the sword has stopped coming since then, right? There's been no cases of magic.
I believe so, but... Yeah, there hasn't been anything since, but who knows? If it was him, we're not safe.
I mean, if it was for the good of the group and there was probable cause, yeah.
Okay, Curse says that they've lost me and they're trying to reconnect me. That's just kind of weird.
If there was probable cause and it was for the good of the group, I'd assist. But as of now, there is no solid evidence.
Uh-huh.
I understand your concern and I admire you for thinking of the group in that way, but... I don't think there's probable cause to be concerned right now, if you don't mind my saying.
Okay, well. So ends that.
Right, well. What shall you do? We are quite at a loss for anything to do, really. Is there anything we can do here?
Can't buy it. Probably said there was like no mercenaries. We probably can't buy anyone off. Well, we might. You probably saw some very, very suspicious looking characters, right?
Not particularly, no. I wasn't just a townsfolk, a blacksmith, a merchant. There was that innkeeper. I bet he could shiv someone up, if you know what I mean. Joke, of course. Small. I'm saying he's small. No one. I'm sorry.
Okay. Well, God, this town's fucking useless.
Honestly, why are we here? Why didn't we go with them? Was there anything we can accomplish here?
I thought maybe there was stuff we could accomplish here, but it doesn't seem like we're able to do much other than fuck around in town.
Nothing else. We can observe the ongoings up until we arrived and take note of that. If this repeating is to persist, we should know everything.
We should, but we already talked to the guard, which theoretically should cause a entire split in what
the beaver effect.
Fuck.
The beaver effect.
I fucking hate you.
You know, the saying where if a beaver chomps down on a tree and that tree floats down river, it could cause a chain reaction of something. But if that beaver never chopped down the tree and chopped down a different one, then a whole different reaction might have happened. It's a very popular theory.
I kind of prefer the multi-universe theory where there's multiple universes.
Well, that just sounds ridiculous.
Yeah, well, fuck you. Yours sounds ridiculous. The fucking beaver theory? Fuck you.
Hey, I didn't make it. I just spread it. I've never found a good beaver. Have you ever seen a beaver you trust? Those teeth. Like daggers.
Can we switch over to our perspective now?
Probably, yeah. This is getting weird. So you guys keep talking about theories and beavers. And you end up at the crossroads.
Oh, hey there, Chaos. How's it going?
Oh, you're all here. That's awkward.
Wait, what?
Never mind. It was leftover tokens.
Damn it. I was gonna hope there was some fucking duper crazy bullshit. But okay, no, we're just here.
You made it to the crossroads, but you didn't.
Let's go down.
Encounter anybody yet? Down? Oh, you wanna go down?
Yeah, to the corpses.
Maybe that's where they were last time. And it's been an hour, right? So it's like 9 in the morning?
About 9. Huh. Look at that. You make it down to the edge of the cave and... Well, as you can see, there's not much to see.
There is a missing road.
King Hunter's what? Grotto. Fuck.
Stan, let's hide inside the cave.
I can already sufficiently say this DLC is worse than Captain Scarlet.
What?
He's still playing Borderlands.
Okay, for some reason I don't see the road on my screen because I'm looking at the stream. There's a road there and the tokens. I don't see a road or tokens.
No, the tokens aren't there.
No.
The road is, the tokens aren't.
What tokens? Your tokens?
You know, it'd be super cool if we could get multiples of us.
I only see the two top tiles of road at the top of the screen. I see nothing else.
That's very peculiar.
Two Chaos's backing plans. Things could work.
Nick, wait, hold on. Hunter's Grotto is worse than Captain Scarlet?
Oh, it's fucking... How? Hey, you wanted... Hey, remember the fucking skiff? Oh, that was a fucking boat. Have fun.
Wait, you have the skiff again?
No, there's a boat, but it's still an alternative vehicle and
I've actually never played it, so actually don't really want too many spoilers.
Okay, well, I already hate it more than Captain Scarlet.
Yeah, I'm looking at the stream, I see the mountain and the cave, and I see the two tokens that Nick is seeing. I only have the two top tiles of road.
Well then.
That's peculiar.
Ow. Ow. Ow.
My fucking phone fell behind my bed. I'm trying to retrieve it. To no avail.
Oh no. How are you also going to play Pokemon Go?
I'm actually reading the chat with that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You do that.
Alright, so what are you guys going to do?
Just hide out in the cave and watch what happened and wait for something to happen, I guess.
Alright, I guess I'll do that and fuck the phone. Meh. Alright. Also, it's almost 3 a.m., so... Let's do this. Let's continue on a little bit longer. Alright, so we'll just say, you guys decided to hide in the cave, is that correct?
Yeah.
It's in just the entrance so you can see what happens out here.
Yes.
Alright. Alright. So... You wait here, and you decide, okay, you know what? There's nothing here. Let's wait here a bit. Maybe we'll see what happened. About, I want to say, an hour passes. And you see the patrol group come in. You see the two patrol groups face each other. And they seem to be talking. And it doesn't seem hostile from what you can see. This goes on for about 10 minutes. I don't have the... Cavalry or anything here, patrol, because I don't think I fucking need it. But hey, they're talking. Pretend they are. Use your imagination. And they start fucking walking away from each other. All things considered, definitely no bloodshed, definitely no corpses.
Stan!
But just as they... As they get to about a decent way from each other... You see a massive red light. Blinding, even. You can't even look at this light, so you have to look away. And when you look back, total war has broken out. Two sides are fighting each other, these two small groups. Stabbing, lots of stabbing. Stab. What do you do?
Assist them. Go.
We assist.
Alright, you run out. Well, if I could fucking... That's not it. That's a rock. I don't want to move that rock. Move out.
I still can't see the map, just so you know.
Great.
Should I try to rejoin?
Maybe.
Just retell
me. Okay, I'll be right back.
Meanwhile, right back. Iggy will add tokens.
There. Oh, I guess I could do that. Oh, they changed how the tokens work in this shit. Like, how you search it up, it's on a weird drop-down menu now, and it's, like, very weird.
Ah.
You wouldn't know unless you've tried to make shit. But I guess you've searched for tokens before, but it's all really weird now. It's a lot harder to find stuff.
Well, that sucks.
I still only have the two pieces of road. Why is this happening to me?
How could
Wait, hold on a second. I wonder if I go to the map.
Mistakes, but life
do you see anything
on.
Happening?
Yeah, you moved it.
And
now there's two.
No. I see nothing happening.
Okay. Nothing. At all.
Nothing. Try moving the two top tile up. Yeah, now something's moving. Now something's moving.
But nothing else.
Nothing else.
Okay, then you're fucked.
I only see the two top tiles of road and that piece you just moved.
Well, no, we can sufficiently stop here.
Well, hold on, I want to say one last thing. They're you go out to fucking intervene, but these guys are fighting so fiercely it's over before you can even say anything. And everyone's been stabbed and fallen off. The horses run away into the distance and everyone's down.
I couldn't have even thrown my rocks at them.
They fought. Rocks. Like, as soon as you regained sight, they were already fucking at each other's throats.
So where exactly did the light appear?
Like, right in the middle of the crossroads.
Just to investigate, I'm going to knock the sign over.
Well, like, where the crossroads would have been. This crossroads is a little bit upward.
Oh.
Like, it's just out of view, but I guess you can go and do that.
Okay, so it happened right above the crossroads. Hmm. The light must be exactly when time goes screwy.
I don't see how that works, though. Like... Sure, it worked this morning, but what happens here, time-wise? Does it switch to an alternate timeline? Like, that seems a bit far-fetched to me.
Well, who knows? The mysterious light of red, the dead bodies, the two kings.
Anyway,
where's the book?
Matchy, check the book. Check the magic book thing.
I open it.
It's still blank and still inactive.
Put it back. All right, then. Squire, grab the swords, and we'll continue on to Lequus.
Grab all the swords.
Mystery
again.
Of the book. Mystery of the light. The dead soldiers. The two cities. And where's the book? All this and more answered next time on DnDRailed.
Really?
It's late.
It's only. We've only been up for like 2 hours, 38 minutes, and 5 seconds, six.
Listen, I had to do so much fucking technical shit today. Also fucking... I'm tired.
Alright.
Yes.
Fair enough.
Plus, it's a decent cliffhanger. I really wanted to cliffhang when the first time loop happened, but hey.
It's another cliffhanger!
I'm sad I'm sad I lost all my swords from the first day.
I'll update your shit next time as well.
Hey. We don't have the goals from yesterday, do we?
It's D&D. Yeah. Cliffhangers. Chris wants to kill me. There's time loops going on.
Okay.
Oh, shit.
Another weird thing. On the D&D Railed stream, the entertainer is invisible to me. All of the stuff on the left side of the screen, besides matching
it. Did your, graphics card shoot itself or something? Or
no,
processor?
No. I will take a screenshot right now. One moment.
I know. I don't distrust you. I believe you.
Oh, the Augustus and the Entertainer just zoomed in, but they're, most of the items and Stan are still invisible.
So, yeah.
He's basically everything. Basically, everything under the Met and the level 4 are invisible. And some of Augustus's items and some of Chaos's items and some of Mechie's. Okay, Stan just zoomed in. Scrap just zoomed in.
I don't
in.
Need a play-by-play, I believe you.
Okay, let's just plug our stuff and go to bed. It's late.
Well, I bet you guys didn't see that coming, did you?
What, the time loop?
Interesting plots, I hope, anyway.
More yeah, it's pretty good. I definitely... Uh-huh. I was not expecting it to...
At least I still have the bed sheet since I stole it today, but it's going to be missing tomorrow.
How will you fix your predicament? How will you find the book?
How did we get out of the...
Pretzels.
How do you get out of the loop?
How did we get out of the inn, though? Like, did we pop out and the inn owner's like, what the fuck?
Pretty much, yeah. I forgot to say that. But yeah, he was like, what the fuck?
But we had the keys. Wouldn't the keys have disappeared or whatever?
Yeah, but you didn't lock the rooms behind you. You just opened the doors and went out.
So I did steal their bed sheets, too. Got it.
You didn't go in their rooms.
But I did, though. I said I was going to steal all their bed sheets. But when? You said I couldn't do that because...
That never happened!
I told you I took the bedsheets from my room, then I went to their bedrooms to steal their bedsheets, but you said that they had locked the doors behind them. And seeing as they didn't have the keys to lock their doors, then what?
Okay, they closed the doors behind them. First off. Secondly, why the fuck would they ever let you in their rooms?
They didn't have to be in their rooms for me to take their, to take stuff.
Oh no, you don't have to be in the location of something that you want to steal, that's not how that works.
If the room is unlocked, I can go in there.
Except everyone left, including you. Anyway,
like,
fucking...
Goes, what the fuck? And then we just kind of fuck off at that point.
As I saw it, you woke up, you said you took your sheets, you fucking left after I said you probably can't get in there. Anyway. There you go. Fucking D&D. It only took an hour late. Oh well.
I'm eating pretzels.
Started an hour late. Good for you. You're supposed to be doing the outro, motherfucker.
I'm trying to, but you guys were talking, so I couldn't. So I started eating some pretzels.
Hey, Great Arc's here. When's he get here?
Hey, Nick, buddy? John Cena.
Oh.
Yeah, Fluffy's still alive. They haven't done anything with Fluffy.
Final
He's just
countdown.
Kind of there.
Final countdown.
I tried to cover,
fucking choke.
I tried to cover my mouth there, but like pretzel stuffs just like kept spitting out onto my hand. Anyway, our wonderful DM here, Eggy, he has a channel. That's it up there.
Yeah, you're whatnot. Looking at it, right?
Yo, Undertale, where's that been?
Wash salsa. Hello.
Yup.
Yeah, you could stop looking at that, go away, do something else.
As we got Chris here. He did stuff 11 months ago.
Yeah. Gonna continue the Pokemon Zeta?
Maybe, possibly, who the fuck?
If he wants
I'll
to, record
we can. Something.
Anyway, then we got Ian. He made something
this
like 2 weeks
ago. This is the obligatory
ago.
Plug scene because... I don't know,
hey,
Nick does it.
I've been visiting family for 2 weeks.
What exactly
well,
do
you
I?
Well, you didn't exactly, you know, make an update or anything on your Twitter. Because you don't have a Twitter.
Oh.
Like, when I went out of the country, hang on a second.
Oh, God.
Probably didn't update your Twitter, and now you're just like, well, now I'm a fucking hypocrite.
No, I updated my Twitter.
What, did you make more fucking Aristotle quotes?
I did not know.
Just fucking Should end be... this shit. We don't need plugging.
Like right here. I'll be out of the house. So no content next week. Yes, it's a simple tweet. Right there.
And Nick is still really bad at outros.
Ian, stop fucking it up. You always mistime that. You always say it way too early. And it gets fucked up.
I say it right on time. You just don't take the chance. because Nick, you are still really bad at outros.
Ian, I haven't even plugged my shit yet.
You're really bad at impersonations. No one cares about your shit.
Oh, look, it's Borderlands 2 with me, Chris, and Iggy.
Are you fucking kidding me?
No, I'm uploading the VODs. They're pretty good.
Are they?
My phone. It's still stuck behind my...
We make a good few jokes. It's pretty nice.
Do a thing!
I'm doing the thing!
Oh, why did we gain like fucking 3 viewers at the outro?
I don't know. I guess because Ark just keeps talking in chat, I guess. Oh yeah.
Wait, okay. No, yeah, comments totally equal views. That's exactly how that works.
I don't know, people
if
see
you
it.
If you keep typing enough in chat, our views will exceed into the thousands.
Anyway, chat update.
Didn't you know?
Fuck, it's still broken.
It's over 9,000!
My god.
Why is this shit still broken? Damn it.
Art, the guy we paid to say positive shit in chat.
Why does chat update not work anymore? Totally. Intermission, no.
Oh my god. What are you doing?
Everything's broken.
How do you physically kill these guys?
So shut it down. Kill it. Kill it.
Anyway.
Go to bed.
Thank you all for watching.
Now your stream is just black. What the fuck?
What? I put up the intermission screen.
Oh,
there it is. Yeah.
It was like... Black for like 3 seconds.
Wow, racist.
Your ass fucking intermission screen with fucking out of place Warframe. One appropriate Tim Turner.
I play Warframe!
The Joey doing a thumbs up for some reason, and then just the panty shot of fucking
Daily Lives of High School Boys. Yeah.
What is that? Where does that come in? How does that relate?
It's just a funny gif about anime!
Do you watch anime with people? That's weeks.
Is this what we want to represent as anime?
What happened to the intermission screen I made you like a year ago?
Oh, I still have that.
It's DnDRailed. This is his new one that's really shit.
I agree. My original one was better, remember?
It's just a plain picture, but this has GIFs and music. Persona 4 music,
we
by the way, which is awesome.
We pay Ark another 50 cents every time he says it's free.
If you spam it, then you're gonna make a lot of money.
Within a 30-second cooldown.
Yeah. Intermission screens.
We talk about anime fairly recently, fairly frequently, actually.
Yeah, and Japan Time, even named after why we talk about anime. Yeah.
It was so horribly named, though. So horribly named!
You're the one who suggested it!
Is fucking Quasha Salsa already a mod? Really?
He said 2 things in chat, which is good
My
enough.
My god.
It's enough.
Just let us go to bed.
I will in a second, after people take in my intermission screen a bit more.
Also, Salsa said before it became a mod, too much fucking promotion. Make this quick and make it fucking succinct.
Nick, do you even still have my original intermission screen?
I just showed,
showed it.
I showed it! I'm showing it now!
I haven't seen it on the stream yet.
Oh my god. How far behind
Who
is...
Who fucking cares?
Whatever.
Oh, come on, just...
fine.
This is why I fucking didn't want to do it for 2 months.
Thank
you. This is why I didn't do it for 2 months. This shit.
No, that's the title screen card. I meant the...
My god.
The one that literally says intermission, it's my mascot holding the.
Oh, I still have that. It's that I don't have it.
In my skin.
Yeah, I.